the champagne pop. It's my house, come on, turn it up. Hear a knock on the door and the night begins. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to WrestleMania, the finale of year one, the biggest event of the year, with 101,000 people in attendance. Welcome to Arlington, Texas. Let's get this show on the road. It is the most anticipated night of the year. Why waste any more time? And here we go to open up WrestleMania, a fourth match on the night, not really official, but you know what, why not? It's an eight-woman battle royale. First up will be Kat Easley.
It's an eight-woman battle royal, making her way to the ring, representing the iconic duo from Rapid City, South Dakota, Catherine Eaton.
Kat Easley, former Chaos Superstar, now Velocity Superstar, looking to make her name made here in this eight-woman battle royale. Eight people thrown over the top rope. Seven of them, I should say, thrown over the top rope. One winner. Who is it going to be to boost yourself and get a shot at WrestleMania? That'd be nice. Help boost your ego a little bit too, right? Boost your name. Well, here's Kat Easley coming out first, and Kat is looking to make her name made here tonight at the biggest night of the year. And here comes matchup number two from Chaos. We have Kari Hunter set to make her way out to the ring. Kari's got a fairly good chance at winning here tonight, I'd say. Kari Hunter's been impressive. We'll see if she can do here tonight at this eight-woman battle royale. Here comes Kari Hunter.
And representing the Hit Squad from Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, Kari Hunter.
And our next entrant, who bounced back and forth between Chaos and Velocity a little bit, but now another Chaos Demon style. Here come Dolly Bo! Here tonight at WrestleMania, Dolly Bo looking to make her name made just like seven other women here. Dolly Bo definitely been a kind of, I guess she hasn't been on a lot of matches, has she? She's been on a couple, but nothing too major. If she's looking to make that change here tonight and win here this eight-woman battle royale at WrestleMania. And here comes the next opponent. It's gonna be Allie Cook. And she's got a little bit of a hairstyle change tonight. Look at that. Allie Cook from Velocity. She's been very, very good at the late. We'll see if she can make that happen here tonight in the Fake One Battle Royale.
Thank you.
And next opponent from Chaos, we're going to have Rainbow 207. Interesting competitive here, but why not? Rainbow 207 looking to make a change in their career here tonight. Rainbow 207 has not won a singles match yet. I want to point that out. This isn't a singles match, obviously, but I, you know, fun fact. She has not won a singles match. She's got one of the worst records in the entire GCW roster, men and women. She's got one of the worst records. So, Rainbow doesn't have too much to be proud of, I'd say, but look, sometimes you just gotta do what you gotta do. Maybe the Battle Royale will change that for her. I doubt it, though. And our next entrant here from Chaos, one of the better superstars in the upper card. Here comes Paige Branson, looking to make her name made here tonight at the Show of the Immortals. Paige Branson, never give up.
And representing Money Incorporated from Kiev, Ukraine, Paige Branson.
Two entrants to go, and here's our next one. Here comes Vonnie Tovar from Velocity. I do wonder what's going to go down here. Vonnie Tovar, not really sure what to think of her. Kind of good and bad at the same time, depending on how you look at it. Record certainly doesn't say much. Vonnie Tovar here tonight, looking to get a win, and this will be a huge win for her career, that's for sure. Question is she able to get seven other women, survive seven other women? I don't know. And our final entrant here tonight, looking to make her name, and here come Sweet Janie from Velocity.
And their opponent from Virginia, Sweet Janie.
These eight women looking to make a huge, huge turn for their own lives here, for their own good. And to survive with them and other women is not an easy thing to do. Survive with other people, even if you're a man or a woman, doesn't matter. It is very, very hard to do. And one of these women are going to have to get extremely lucky to be able to win here tonight. And I don't doubt that there is going to be a surprise or two. And here we go. 8 women Battle Royale is underway. 8 women looking to get a win here tonight. Oh my god, Allie Cook already over the top rope! Whoa, whoa, whoa! Allie Cook was almost eliminated right away by Cardi Hunter. That would have been kind of embarrassing, I'm not gonna lie. But these women looking to make a change for themselves here! It's hard to keep up with what goes on in the ring in these kind of matches, but it's entertaining when you get towards the end. That's for sure. Cardi Hunter trying to eliminate Allie Cook again. You have to wonder what the game plan here has to be in these kind of matches. Not many people are able to kind of, I guess, make their way in the match. They're not able to make their way, kind of. This is only people that aren't competing at WrestleMania, right? Would you rather be in the Battle Royale or compete at WrestleMania? I think the obvious choice is to compete at WrestleMania, right? I mean, the Battle Royale is great, but it's not really, like, you know, I mean, it's an official match, but it's not, like, a real, it's kind of just a thing to boost and get more people at WrestleMania, right? So I don't know if it's exactly the biggest thing you got. Ronnie Trevor trying to eliminate Sweet Janie here. Looks like Sweet Janie's going to be able to hang on, though. Back and forth, these two against the ropes. Look at them. Zoey and Rainbow struggling a little bit. It's hard to see, but what is going on at this point? Rainbow trying to eliminate Zoey Bowl here. And now Ronnie slamming Sweet Janie down. And now the Ikari are still going at it. Jesus Christ. Rainbow trying to eliminate Zoey, but Zoey's going to survive. One of these women are gonna have to get eliminated soon so I can actually tell what's going on a little better, you know what I mean? Right now I have no clue. I have no clue what's going on, I'm gonna be honest with you. Paige Branson over the top rope, Cat easily now headed to the top. Look at this takedown, Branson with the Hurricane Rana. Zoey Bowl against the rope, turning it back. But Kari Hunter gonna push Allie Cook against the rope. Kari trying to go for the elimination on Allie Cook. Is she gonna be able to get her? But look at this, Rainbow trying to eliminate Zoey as well. Boom! And then now they cooked down. Oh, look at this, Vonnie! Boom, and a top rope eliminated by Sweet Janie. We're down to seven women. Vonnie Tobar has been eliminated. Allie Cook taking Sweet Janie into the corner. Oh my God, what is going on? I don't know who's attacking who anymore. Paige Branson trying to eliminate Allie Cook. Boom! Right hand to Zoey Bowl. Not gonna work. Allie Cook and stay alive here yet again. Paige Branson! Boom! What a suplex to Cook! Oh my God! Power bomb by Sweet Janie! Jesus Christ, dude. These guys are ruthless! Sometimes they even wonder how they're going to be able to survive. I would never be able to survive this long in a match, right? Doesn't matter what it is. Even if it is just a battle, I would never. Boom! Paige Branson slamming Zoey Bowl down. Cat Easley, oh, eliminates Rainbow 207! Rainbow is gone, eliminated by Cat Easley. Allie Cook, oh no, Sweet Janie gonna drop her down! I have to try to eliminate Zoey Bowl here, Kari. Looking for a quick elimination. Uh-oh, Allie Cook in trouble! Oh, Zoey's been eliminated by Kari Hunter, and Allie Cook eliminated by Sweet Janie, we are down to four! Paige, Sweet Janie, Kari Hunter, and Cat Easley. Paige going after Cat while Kari goes after Sweet Janie. What a suplex. Cat trying to eliminate Paige Branson here, trying to get rid of her. Kari Hunter with the plan. Oh, she got her. Kari. Boom. Lumbar check. Trying to put away Sweet Janie. She got a chance. Oh my God. Kari, relax. What just happened over there? Kari, got her up. Here we go. Kari Hunter slams her down. The Bloodborne from Kari. Definitely a brutal move. I don't think Janie is ready for that. Kari Hunter definitely looking like the best one of this match so far. Maybe Paige Branson along at number two. Or you could argue through Janie. Kari goes for a knee, but Cat out of the way. Cat with a right. Now, oh, monkey flip to Kari on turn. Now, oh, Paige is going for an AA, but Sweet Janie caught her. Oh! Cat Easy ran right into her on accident. But they're going to keep going at it. Doesn't matter. Kari Hunter from behind on Cat Easy. Cat goes back the other way with the back elbow. That is trying to strike Kari Hunter. Goes back the other way. Look at that backbreaker from Sweet Janie. What a knee by Kari. Now, Kari trying to turn it around, but Cat Easy is going to make her go back. Oh, backbreaker by Sweet Janie. Paige in the corner. Kari Hunter being attacked by Sweet Janie. What a knee by Cat Easley. And now, oh, Kari turning it back around. Oh, we Cat Easley over the top eliminates Kari Hunter out of nowhere. Kari, who was probably the best one in the match so far, has just been eliminated. Sweet Janie, Paige Branson, and Cat Easley, the final three in the Battle Royale. Cat Easley. What's the plan here? Trying to attack Paige Branson. They're going to go back the other way. Paige Branson trying to carry them back the other way with Cat Easley. Sweet Janie. Oh, watch against the rope. Oh, trying to go for a hip strike, but Oh, no, going after 3 Jennings. I don't know what's going on. Oh, look at it. Oh, working together. Russian leg sweep for 3 Jennings. Page and Cat Easley with a little lion. Cat Easley over the top. Watch out. Whoa. Eliminated 3 Jennings. I don't know what, I don't know who got the elimination. Was it Cat or Page? I think it was Cat. But Page trying to eliminate Cat. Now, Cat going to be able to stay out of it. We are down the two. Paige Branson and Cat Easley to win this battle. Oh, Paige has got her up. Oh, wait for the aim. No. Cat Easley turns it around with an elbow strike. What a reversal on the AA. Attitude adjustment almost ended this battle off for Cat Easley. Cat got Paige Branson in the corner. Cat Easley, what's the plan here? Cage. Oh, no. Cat taking to the other corner. Or Cat taking Paige to the other corner. Cat Easley, what's the plan here in this battle royale? Cat Easley, kick to Paige Branson. Cat Easley, oh, clothesline takedown, Paige and Cat Easley has won the battle royale. You kidding me? I pulled a pre-board Cat. I gotta give it to her though, and I'm pressing before the with it. 4 elimination? I don't know, but what a win by Cat Easley. She's won the WrestleMania Women's Battle Royale. I get that goal. Good job, Paige. I mean, good job, Cat. Paige lost. Paige did not win. Excuse me. Paige got eliminated by Cat Easley, but hey, you know what? What a win! I'll give it to her.
Here is your winner, Catherine Eaton.
Cat Easley debuting a new look for WrestleMania after being gone for a while, and Cat's gonna come back and win it too. What a win by Cat Easley at WrestleMania. That ought to boost your career, right? WrestleMania, and it's one of the most anticipated matches just because it's The Undertaker. He challenges Mattel Lopez for the United States Championship all the way since back at the Elimination Chamber. The Undertaker made his way out. He chokeslammed him, and since then, it's been a little heated, and now we get to come to closure here at WrestleMania. The Undertaker versus Mattel Lopez to start off the big show. If you remember, a while back, there was a lot of heat between The Undertaker and Brock Lesnar, Undertaker Shawn Michaels, Undertaker Triple H, and the fact that he's here now in PTW to face Mattel Lopez, it just only added to it. The Undertaker only losing 2 WrestleMania matches in his career, 1 against Brock Lesnar and 2 against Roman Reigns, and this might be his 3rd going against Mattel Lopez for the United States Championship. The man is aging, Mattel Lopez a young star, looking to retain his title against one of the biggest legends in all of wrestling and sports entertainment. And here comes the champion. He's got to do everything in his power to retain here tonight. And honestly, this is no normal night. This is no normal match. This is The Undertaker and Mateo Lopez. I know that sounds crazy for people to listen to. The Undertaker coming back at Extreme Rules and now finally making an appearance at WrestleMania. People cannot believe their eyes. Neither can I, man. The Undertaker's back and he's in PCW. Imagine that, and the fact that he's going against someone like Mateo Lopez, a young star who doesn't have a lot of momentum, needs to kind of prove himself. This is exactly how Mateo Lopez can do it, and that is defending his championship against one of the most biggest threats in all of wrestling history, and of course a Hall of Famer and a wrestling legend all around the world.
Introducing the challenger from Death Valley, weighing in at 299 pounds, The Undertaker! And introducing the champion from Indianapolis, Indiana, weighing in at 250 pounds. He is the WWE United States Champion.
The Undertaker and Mateo Lopez set the score. Referee, ring that bell. It is time. Undertaker and Mateo Lopez for the United States Championship. It's going to be an interesting contest because, like we said before, Mateo Lopez having to go against the wrestling legend in The Undertaker, the dead man, the phenom. He's looking to do everything into this map and go back to his old self just to win the United States Championship here tonight. Mateo Lopez running down with the fifth drop. I would say this is probably Mateo Lopez's biggest match of his career. the most anticipated one for his career as well. I mean, he's defended against people of the likes of John Fluky. He's faced people like TCT, but he has never faced a guy like The Undertaker. Never faced someone of that caliber of legend status. Mateo Lopez got The Undertaker up. Look at that. Oh my goodness. Able to get him down with the Michinoku driver. Mateo Lopez looking to stay on top. Don't let The Undertaker get his offense. That is where he holds the feed. One of the most prolific strikers in the game. Undertaker caught with a stomp by Mateo Lopez. Mateo Lopez now waiting down left hand, trying to wear down Taker as much as he can. Lopez looking to capitalize in any way he can, trying to keep him down and wear him out. If you're able to take him down because of his age, that's one advantage that you can get early in a matchup. Undertaker forcing
another one. Tattoos?
Mateo? I don't think so, no. Whoa! Undertaker! Going back about a couple 20 years with a flipping clothesline. Oh my goodness. Mateo Lopez got him back to the seat. Mateo Lopez, whoa! Undertaker thrown right down to the map. I'm kind of surprised that Mateo Lopez had no tattoos. I'm not going to lie, dude. I would think that he's the guy that would have a tattoo. You know, a tattoo
even
on his...
Even a dead man has tattoos.
Yeah, right? Mateo Lopez, oh, no, Undertaker able to roll out of the way. Whoa, my goodness! Mateo Lopez walked up to him for an attack, and Undertaker said, get out my face! Throat thrust.
Get out my face.
Undertaker turned the back around, a right hand to back of Mateo Lopez. Undertaker! Slides him down! We said before, one of the most prolific strikers in the game, and he's just proving that right here, right now, is nothing has changed. Undertaker with Lopez. Boom! Right into the ring post, shoulder first! Undertaker trying to now capitalize on Mateo Lopez being down. Now these people start to have a lot of momentum going into this match, and this is definitely one way to change it. Another throat thrust by The Undertaker.
Throat thrust?
Mm-hmm, throat thrust. The Undertaker's daughter, the Archangel, has a match on night two. Undertaker's looking to go 1-0. Oh my goodness, that PCW's WrestleMania. Undertaker, boom! Another one in the ring post. Undertaker yet again with Mateo Lopez on his feet. Not giving up hope, yet a right hand. Another right hand to Mateo Lopez. Mateo Lopez taking off the ropes. Undertaker with that boot takes him down. Lopez is struggling to get the offense. Go Mateo Lopez. Oh my goodness, the power of Lopez. They're gonna come out. Oh! With an elbow drop, The Undertaker sat right up. One of the funny. Everybody loves to get a good cheer out of that one. Undertaker with the neck breaker. The loop to the crowd. Undertaker maybe looking to put this thing away soon. Mateo Lopez positioned against the rope, the left hand by The Undertaker. Whoa! An Undertaker dribbling over the top rope by Mateo Lopez. Lopez waiting patiently for The Undertaker. Back in the ring, over top, and a full smash takes out the Phenom. Exactly what you love to see. Mateo Lopez's high-flying ability may come handy in a match with The Undertaker. Only losing two matches at WrestleMania. This is looking to be a third. Mateo Lopez got The Undertaker. Whoa! Undertaker able to turn it around. The power of Taker over Gumman. Mateo Lopez. Oh my god! The disrespect to the WWE legend, The Undertaker. Lopez trying to get the crowd on his side now, but I don't know if they improved too much. Mateo Lopez running through, took down The Undertaker. Another clothesline to take him down. Lopez with Taker in the corner. Mateo Lopez, boom! Not done yet. Here he comes! A crossbody to take down The Undertaker. And then a cover quickly to try and put him away. Quickly and early, count of one, count of two, a kick out by The Undertaker.
What's the difference between that and a steal?
What'd you say?
What's the difference between that and a steal?
Crossbody? A spear. Whoa. Boom, a running power bomb. A spear is when you kind of dive into it and you kind of, like, you shoulder thrust somebody, but, like, super fast, kind of hard. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And, crossbody, you could. You know, you hit him with your mid-body, your mid-core. What's Mateo Lopez doing? Lopez.
He wants to be outside.
I think he needed a second to get away from The Undertaker. I understand it. Roleplay for The Undertaker. Mateo Lopez, what's the plan here? Lopez trying to catch him, but The Undertaker. And turn him back the other way. Boom! Undertaker. Uh-oh! Undertaker! He's got him up! Chuck slammed to Mateo Lopez! And the Phenom is finally getting his momentum back, getting his mojo back. You could see a new United States champion in just a moment. The Undertaker trying to go. Oh! Clothesline, Mateo was able to dodge out of the way. Oh, no, no, no. Undertaker Hell of Gay locked it in. Trying to tap out the United States champion. One of the most deadly finishers in all of sports entertainment. Mateo Lopez, the right hand, able to get out of it. He's trying. He's able to escape. Not many people can escape that move. Mateo Lopez is not one of them. A back elbow. Whoa! Undertaker right up. Look at that. Mateo Lopez doesn't know what to think. I wouldn't either. Taker makes him bleed. Lopez in a brutal match so far. It's not even Extreme Rules, and this is already hard to watch. Undertaker maybe looking to put things away for good. Undertaker's got Mateo Lopez. Plays them, oh, right in the corner. And Lopez caught with a right hand by the Undertaker. And then Mateo Lopez able to turn it around. And Lopez, oh, caught again. The Undertaker flooding through with a cross flag. Mateo Lopez caught again. Undertaker drops him under the top turnbuckle. Off the rope here. Come with a big boot right to the face. And the power inside. Completely overcoming Mateo Lopez. One of the most hardest title defenses for Mateo Lopez is now in queue. Undertaker looking for it. Tombstone pile driver. The one of the most deadly moves of all time. And Mateo Lopez able to get his foot under the bottom rope. Luckily for Lopez, that is not the end of it yet. Undertaker, though, he's not done with it. Taker's got him up. Undertaker up high. Last ride. The Undertaker with the last ride. Throwback to the American Badass. And then a cover. Count of one. Count of two. Lopez there. Barely able to kick out. United States Championship still belongs to Mateo. The Undertaker looking to make that not happen. Undertaker got him up. No, no, no. Mateo Lopez, they want to turn it back the other way. Undertaker. Oh! Mateo Lopez tried to go for a shoulder thrust, but the Undertaker able to counter. Taker, what's the plan now? Undertaker got him up. Look at this. Undertaker trying to muster. Oh my god. Oh my god. Mateo Lopez. Tombstone. Able to get one of his own. And then a cover. Referee one. The old Tombstone and the Undertaker kicked out. Mateo Lopez went for his own, and look at this. Mateo Lopez going for the blockbuster. The Undertaker in trouble. Ooh, blockbuster. Mateo Lopez trying to put the Undertaker away. Mateo the championship. Count of one. Count of two. Undertaker barely able to get the shoulder up on Mateo Lopez. He tried his best. But Mateo Lopez still cannot find a way to put away the dead man. Lopez in the corner trying again. He's trying again. Mateo Lopez. Tornado into Gary. This might do it. Come on. He's gonna cover. Count of two. No. Again. The Undertaker kicked out. I don't think Mateo Lopez gonna believe it. I can't believe it. Two finishes in a row is still not enough to put away the Phenom. Don't ask me how. I have no clue, man. I have zero clue. Mateo Lopez rolls you up the snapmare. Trying to get him down to get a front kick. Oh my god, oh no. Oh, the Undertaker turning the tide! And a right hand behind him, Mateo Lopez. Mateo Lopez, though, able to react accordingly. Trying to take down the Undertaker. Undertaker strikes back with the right hand! All the way into the corner, Mateo Lopez goes sliding. Undertaker, though, look at the hard work he's putting into this match on the top rope with Mateo Lopez. The Undertaker, an arm drag! Crushing him on the bottom! And now, boom again! Undertaker targeting the arms in the core. Mateo Lopez trying to take down all his offense if he can. Right hand by Taker. Another right against the ropes. Now the Undertaker looking to finish things off. On top. Got him up. Swings him under the top rope. Brutal move by the dead man. Going for it again. Looking for a choke there from Mateo Lopez. And what a counter. Lopez a clothesline on a top rope. And Lopez looking to catch his breath, much deserving of so. I don't even know how you're able to stay alive this long with The Undertaker. Don't ask me, man. I have no clue. Mateo Lopez, able to barely get him back on his feet. The fatigue is getting to him. Mateo Lopez on the outside, telling him to get up. Mateo Lopez on the springboard looking for something. Mateo Lopez off that springboard! Oh! Blockbuster! From off the springboard! You gotta be kidding me! Into the cover! One! Two! No! Even modifying his own move, the blockbuster is still not enough to put away the dead man. WrestleMania kicked off, and I don't think there's any better way, to be honest. Trying to go for the Undertaker, able to turn it back to the ring. Went for a big move right to the back of the head. Mateo Lopez suffering that one. Lopez running through. Caught him with a swing blade. The Undertaker down. Mateo Lopez looking. Oh my god, is he going to be able to lift all that up? There's no way a monkey flip is able to get all that up. 299 pounds of muscle. The corner, maybe looking to put this thing away right now. Undertaker's in trouble. The Phenom, Cole with the third. Another blockbuster by Mateo Lopez. Into the cover. Count of two. Mateo Lopez has pinned the Undertaker, and he will retain. What better way to do it at WrestleMania? Nobody, and I mean barely anybody, I mean two people have done it. Mateo Lopez is now a third. The Undertaker has been pinned at his hometown, WrestleMania. If you would have told me at Chaos Week 1 that we would see Mateo Lopez with The Undertaker for United States Championship at WrestleMania, I would laugh at you. But ladies and gentlemen, we're here now, and Mateo Lopez has retained in his biggest match of his career by far. All congratulations to him, man. The Undertaker coming back for two tag team matches and one singles match at Mania, just where he belongs.
The WWE United States Champion.
Mateo Lopez able to retain, and what a huge match for his career. If you really don't have the respect for Mateo Lopez right now, I don't know what you're talking about. This guy pinning The Undertaker, that means he is on the level of people like Brock Lesnar and, of course, Roman Reigns. And if you were to tell me that as well, Mateo Lopez, I wouldn't believe you. But we're seeing it here live tonight. The first map on the card is gone. Mateo Lopez is still your United States Champion.
Welcome to my house, baby, take control. Morning comes and you know that you wanna stay. Close the blinds, let's pretend that the time has changed. Keep our clothes on the floor, open up champagne. Let's continue tonight, come on, celebrate. That's how we do. Sometimes you gotta stay in, and you know where I live. Yeah, you know what we is. Sometimes you gotta stay.
And our second match on your WrestleMania Night 1 card. Two matches out of eight. This is the second one starting. It is Roy Mullins versus Agent NT versus Rafael Draco for the Legend Championship. And Roy is definitely probably the favorite for this match, or at least the second favorite. Roy Mullins, an absolute powerhouse, a monster in the ring. You get hit with that spear, that jackhammer, you're going right to sleep. Roy Mullins is looking to win the Legend Championship here tonight. Win his first title, of course. And that's going to be interesting because Roy definitely does deserve it. He got a lot of recognition now, and I think if he's able to win it here tonight, that's going to be a huge accomplishment for him in his career. And then we got our second entry here tonight. It's Adrian MT, of course, he has to be there. Why can't we just have a WrestleMania without Adrian MT in it? That's all I want to know. They would make it so much better. You can agree with that, right?
I think it'd make it better, but like, I mean, like, who doesn't want to bully him, though?
You're right, but there's sort of possibility of him winning, and I don't like that. You know what I mean? He could technically win this match. I don't think he will, but he could if he wanted to.
Isn't there a few moves?
It's just a triple threat, normal. But you can use weapons, of course, because you know there's no good use.
Maybe he'll go for a low blow.
You know what? I wouldn't be surprised. I would not be surprised considering this agent out here at WrestleMania. He would ruin a match like that, wouldn't he?
But it's not Echo, though.
Not Echo, but he would still do it. He's still a cheap shot. Is that a hot dog on his... I just realized, does he have a hot dog on his jacket? Look at the left side of the jacket.
He's a hot dog.
No, look right there. Is that a hot dog?
I think that's an emu.
I thought it looked like a hot dog. Anyway, not the point. Hey, Andy, I hope you lose. I hope you fall. I hope you break your leg. Here comes Rafael Draco, the legend champion. He is going to try to defend here tonight against two competitors, Roy and Adrian. Rafael is certainly a favorite, probably the favorite to win this match. And this man, full of charisma. Of course, this man has got to do everything in his power to win that championship back here tonight. A little defended, I guess I could say. But here's Rafael Draco. And here we go, triple threat match about to get underway. Rafael versus Adrian versus Roy for the Legend Championship referee ring the bell. Here we go. Definitely an interesting match on the card here tonight. I hope that Rafael Draco can win it. I hope that he can retain it. Got a quick cover on Roy. Interesting. And a kick out before one. Adrian MT was going to go break it up. I don't see why he would. I know, right?
It happened in like 7. Like, bye guys.
That'd be really embarrassing. Oh, went for a kick. Roy moved out of the way. Rafael Draco, though, got him crapped on Costly. He's already trying to tap him out early in this match. I don't think it's going to happen with Adrian standing there. Oh! Breaking up the pin. Adrian empty with the knee to the side of Roy's head. Rafael getting Adrian back with you. Rafael Draco rolling through with a kick. Boom! Draco doing his absolute best to try and retain his championship here tonight. I don't know. I wouldn't say this is the biggest match of his career, but I'd say it's got higher stake than anything else in his career. I'd say that.
Also, Roy's already hot.
Boom! Yeah, I mean, I got. Oh, whoa, wait a minute. Adrian MT. Noticing Rafael Draco. Well, I was going to say, man, I mean, wow, he's actually really hurt. Did he get injured already? This man is like, he's back up.
I mean, it took him like 2 minutes to get up last time.
Whoa! Tree of War by Adrian MT. Roy Mellon, what's the plan here, Roy? Adrian MT down up top. Roy, boom! A stomp right to the chest. Rafael back on the feet quickly. Now snapmare onto Roy. Oh, look at this, raking the eye of Roy, trying to do everything he can. I respect it though. Rafael Draco got him, flipped him over now into a headlock. Draco working on that technical ability to try and wear down his opponent, which is a smart thing to do, especially in a triple threat match. Take out one, finish the other off. Don't even. Whoa, what the?
Oh, my God.
Hey,
let's go.
Oh my God. Adrian empty into the cover off that back duplex, one, and a kick out by Rafael Draco.
Oh, I got what you said.
What? Oh!
I got what you said. Finish off with... Okay,
moving on. Adrian empty. Oh my God, what is that? Oh! I don't even know what you call that. He did it, though.
The dog
duplex.
What'd the dog do it?
Adrian empty modified Russian leg flew to Roy. Adrian empty.
He looks like a dog. But like
Adrian?
A chihuahua, not a chihuahua. Like a
pitbull,
like no one likes him.
This is a retard. Oh, double foot thump! Roy!
You mean evil?
Whoa! I mean, what the hell happened? Rafael was doing a lap. You know what? I'm glad that he's not on WrestleMania. I just want to do that. It would be a disappointing match. Rafael?
And it's done in 5 seconds. Five
yeah, right? I want to see, like...
The main event.
I want to see, like... Who's the strongest person? Yeah, I want to see the Archangel versus Evil. That'd be funny. Oh,
I guess Evil could be a goal.
I mean, he already
had a goal.
Oh, no, I want to see Adrian in the match. I want to see him beat the scat of Evil. Oh, my God, Roy. Oh, wait, no. Wow, hammer strike from Draco.
He already had a goal.
Evil's not going to get a female, nor will he be a female himself. Frog splash from Draco. Yeah, back to the match, excuse me. Draco with the frog splash. Maybe you're looking to put the thing away right here, right now. I'm going to cover off the frog splash. Referee down one. Count of two, Roy. They want to kick out. Powering out of that beautiful frog splash, Draco. Adrian on the outside. Raphael. What is Adrian doing? Oh, there he is. Adrian from behind. Oh, whoa. Trying to take out Draco, but Draco moved out of the way just in time. Got him, Roy. Got him right there. Adrian from behind with the dropkick to Draco. Roy's going to head outside the ring. Adrian MT trying to take Raphael. Oh, whoa, whoa. Raphael moving out of the way. Got him right there. Oh, my God. Look at this. The Roy with a sledgehammer. Adrian to the cover. Roy breaks it up. Why not just use the hammer to break it up?
Yeah, Roy. I have no idea.
Roy taking Adrian off the ropes. Roy backing up. Oh, wow. Land all the way down. Adrian MT in a little bit of trouble now. Roy is fired up and ready to go. Looking to win the Legend Championship here tonight. I saw that.
What?
The hammer just like did something. Roy got Adrian up. Wow. Toss him across the ring with that suplex. Yeah, for Draco, what's the plan here? Draco gonna take Adrian into his own matters. Looks like a little alliance formed here between Roy and Raphael. Boom! What a suplex by Raphael. And then Roy, oh! What? Tried to end that alliance with the clothesline, but Raphael caught him with a neckbreaker.
Why would you bring a sledgehammer and not use it?
That's what I'm saying. Somebody pick it up.
No one picked it up yet.
Raphael. Uh-oh, I see why! Draco! Moonsault attack to Roy! Into the cover, trying to put it away! To retain his Legends Championship 1! Count of 2! No! Moonsault attack, a beautiful move by Raphael Draco, but it's not enough to retain his title quite yet. Off the springboard, Moonsault by Draco! No, it's Dr. Adrian back in the ring. Dr. Draco, whoa! Able to slam him down, but look at this. I had to go, oh my God, this isn't bad. Raphael Draco got him against the wall now. Draco up top. Draco on the top of Adrian MT struggling. There we go. Now he's in a sledgehammer, but he missed. And Adrian with a dropkick. That was a disappointing use of the sledgehammer. Oh,
it,
no.
It has been 0 out of 1.
No. Sunrise super kick. Stop. Into the cover, Adrian trying to win the Legends Championship. 1 and 0. Oh, Roy's able to break that up. Adrian MT now with the sledgehammer trying to get him, but now, no! Sledgehammer still has not been used properly. Whoa! What the fuck? Did you see that?
Low blow.
No, you can do a low blow. You don't even have to knock the referee down to do that. You can still do a low blow.
Not like brass knuckles.
Still, yeah. There's no DQ. In triple threat match.
Why did you knock the referee down?
Oh, what if my dropkick would not work? Roy. But Adrian able to take him down. Roy, oh, diving under Roy. Taking him up, back body drop! That's not it though. Roy got him! Blind Buster right under the sledgehammer! Roy in the corner, what's he looking for?
I swear, if he jumps off that corner, I'm gonna have to.
Oh, there he goes. Imagine. Roy, watch out right in front! Bear! Oh my God! He leaped into that one! My man went flying, he went surfing! Uh-oh, Raphael from behind. I don't think we realized it yet. Raphael in the corner. Oh, no, man. I don't think we realized it. Yeah, he didn't realize Raphael Draco now. I don't know what... Oh, Jesus, into the corner. Now I got Adrian MT. Break him against the ropes with the plan here. Raphael left hand to Adrian MT. Now got him against the ropes. On the middle rope. Don't forget about Roy in the corner, by the way. Don't forget about Roy.
Yeah, but hey.
There you go. Draco got him. Whoa, my God. Roy, I think he was going for a moonsault attack, but Roy didn't want anything to do with that. And on the right hand, clobbering the face of Raphael Draco. Roy now, got him. Roy, power slam! What is the plan now, Roy? You got a lot of options, might as well use one of them. Roy, a right hand to Raphael Draco, pointing at the move. Draco goes back to the move to right of his own. Trying to get him now, Roy, up the move. Watch out, Draco! Oh, able to shoulder block him. DDT! I think Roy was looking for a very momentous spear, but Raphael Draco met him in the middle. Adrian MT back in the ring. Raphael realized, oh, taking him down with the shoulder block. There we go now. In front of the top. A drop. Able to take down Adrian MT. And up top. Go slam. Again under the sledgehammer. This man is just getting abused on that sledgehammer. And I'm fine with it. Jericho on the top. Frog splash to MT. Beautiful move. An even more beautiful finish. Jericho trying to keep rolling down. We've got a momentous time right here. And now over the top rope. I think he's looking to take on Adrian MT. Yeah, baby, that's the right choice. Rafael Draco doing the right thing. In the corner, here it comes. Draco looking for it. 3-0. Trying to go for the switch of music, but Adrian MT could not let it happen. In the corner, Draco. No. Adrian MT able to turn him back around. MT trying to catch him again. Rafael Draco, though, double knees right to the face. A moment with there under the cover. Didn't land that significantly. I don't think that's going to put him away. Count of two. Whoa. Late kick out by MT. You can tell that he is not quite ready for this. Rafael Draco, beautiful. Whoa! Oh, wait a minute. Try to go for the MT. Go exactly. Not going to have it happen. A right hand. Adrian MT able to move out of the way. Adrian MT. Oh my god, no! Elevated flatliner. No. Avoid the ring. Adrian MT. Tell them to suck it. Avoid trying to take the cover. You idiot. What are you trying to do? Whoa! Adrian MT went into Conroy. Got him again. Take it under Roy. Oh no. Caught again. Adrian MT. Lizzo kick. Into the corner. This is not good right now. Adrian MT in that corner. Try to flash him down, but Roy able to move out of the way. Roy backing up, waiting for a moment to try and attack. Oh, whoa. Roy from behind. Got him up. Whoa! Cut them down onto the mat. Adrian forced to roll out of the ring. Roy sledgehammer. There we go. Using a sledgehammer as intended. Roy with that sledgehammer striking down in the back of Rafael Draco's legs. Over and over again. Trying to incapacitate the Legends champion. Draco, they're taking him off the rope. Draco off the rope. Got him again. Double knee. Adrian backwards. He does blood. Made Roy bleed. Not many people can do that. It is a quick cover. Adrian up. Oh my god. Adrian empty. Frog splash to the back. That's one way to break up a pin. Adrian empty. Trying to get him rolling back elbow. Will not go. Got a sledgehammer. Adrian hits him in the gut. Not going to let it happen. Adrian empty from behind. Adrian empty. No. Pull him out to reverse the field to the sledgehammer. Into the cover. One. Let him right on the... Whoa. Oh my god. Oh my heart. He landed right on the hard part of the sledgehammer, man. Oh no. Dude, come on. Stop this. Sunlight super kick. No. Whoa, please. Is it a cover? Would anyone break it up? Thank God. I was actually having a heart attack. Take the sledgehammer. Put the right into the gut of Adrian MT. Locked it in. Trying to tap out Adrian MT. Working on the foot. Trying to mobilize him as well. But Adrian MT able to escape out of it. Roy Mullins over top of both of these people. Trying to attack Rafael again where he was before. Inverted German suplex right under the sledgehammer again. That hammer is being used as both a weapon and a landing pad. But look at it. Rafael with the roll. Count of one. Count of two out of nowhere. Oh! Rafael Draco with the roll and he wins. Out of all the ways to do it. The possum roll up. One of the most deadliest moves in all sports entertainment. You get rolled up and Roy completely not expecting. I was expecting a different ending than that. But I'm not going to complain. Rafael Draco is still your Legends champion. You love to see it. I got really scared. I thought Adrian MT actually had a moment there. But, what is this? Draco, he's not done yet. He's got a microphone. Okay. Let's go, Rafael. He wants to bring the Intercontinental Championship back? I can't believe this. The Intercontinental Championship was not yet in here, but Rafael Draco asking the crowd, listen to those cheers. They want the Intercontinental title.
Here is your winner, Ralph Drago.
And the choices are decided. Look how that belt looks on Draco. That is a beautiful title to hold. Rafael Draco, forget the Legend Championship. Rafael is your new Intercontinental Champion. I guess you could say he kind of retained it as well. I don't know if you want to say retained or new. I guess it's a little bit of both. But Draco able to take down both Roy and Adrian. He has won the Intercontinental title. Welcome back, Intercontinental Championship. First time on PCW. I want to see how this title win is going to go. Draco, beautifully done here on WrestleMania. And here we go, our third match on the WrestleMania card here tonight is a one-on-one contest, Falls Count Anywhere. June Crable taking on Yumiko Lee at WrestleMania. June Crable and Yumiko have had a lot of history throughout their years, all the way since the beginning of this whole thing. I believe it was week one, Yumiko Lee pinned June Crable. Eventually in the future, they faced at the Mixed Match Challenge. June Crable pinned Yumiko again, but that was by, I believe, was it by roll-up? It was by roll-up. It was by a little sneaky roll-up by June Crable. And then, of course, on Chaos, though, a little bit prior, Yumiko Lee won using brass knuckles, so it's not the most fair way to do it. But, and of course, at the title draft, I forgot to mention that June won the Women's Championship by pinning Yumiko Lee. So they are here again at WrestleMania, looking to fight each other one last time for year one. And it is, and, I mean, look at the attire on her, by the way. That is some clean drip for June Crable. I don't know what's happening to her cape, but we're not going to talk about that. June Crable taking on Yumiko Lee here tonight, and I know Paul is going to be ejaculating.
Ejaculation, Paul.
Paul, I have a question. Do black people come white or black?
Okay, dude, you need to. Okay, do many people. Okay, I don't know. Ask Eric. Do many people come yellow?
They come rainbow. And here I come. Yumiko Lee. Yumiko Lee, I have high expectations for this match. I expect Yumiko Lee to give it her all. She has been impressive regardless of using the brass knuckles by pinning Keely Doji, for example. So Yumiko Lee, get your butt down there. And here we go, match to get on the way. June Crable versus Yumiko Lee. Fall count anywhere. Ring the bell. Hing, ding, ding. June Crable and Yumiko Lee, a lot of rivalry.
Ding, ding, ding.
Shut up. June Crable and Yumiko Lee, a lot of tension between the three with the rivalry. And then a quick cover kick out by Lee. I expect it to be a good match. I expect the two to give it their absolute all and put on a show for the people here in Arlington.
Who do you think is going to win?
Boom!
Who's
I
gonna win?
Think... Honestly, I'm expecting Yumiko Lee to win. I'm going to be completely honest. Yumiko Lee has gotten so much momentum over the past couple of weeks. I think she's got the momentum to be able to take down someone like June Crable. I think she's able to do it. She's going to get that huge push of momentum that she needs. She's able to take down her rival and, of course, probably her biggest opponent she's ever had. She's definitely going to be, you know, on top of the world. But I expect Yumiko Lee to win. If she doesn't, then that's all right. But I expect her to win. Lee turned around. Old school wrestling here at WrestleMania. Locked into a headlock, June Crable. Looking to try and put away Yumiko Lee. June Crable locked again. Oh, Yumiko Lee gonna push her away. A little bit of a stalemate between these two. Oh! Laying down, June Crable beautifully done. And the cover on Yumiko Lee. Count of one and a kick out right away. Yumiko Lee back to her feet. Oh! Tripped up by June Crable trying to keep her down. Crable beautifully done. Look at this. Crable got Yumiko Lee back to her feet. June Crable, what's the plan here? Tripped her up. Oh my god, face first. Poor Yumiko. Oh, stuff right to the back. He's still trying to go as much as he can. Boom! I'm back! Suplex able to catch Yumiko Lee off guard. And June Crable stands tall over her, of course, opponent. Hey. What are you going to do against this point? June Crable is one of the most talented women on the roster. I think she's going to have a little bit of trouble going against someone like this, I would imagine. June Crable off the ropes, run and throw. Boom! A hips off to the back. And against that middle rope too, why not? June Crable, the definition of success. Oh, look at that. Rolled up into the cover. Count of one. Count of two. A kick out by June Crable. Tried to surprise it with that one. June Crable, oh, a drop kick right there. Let's see. Yumiko Lee, the spirit wolf. Oh, whoa. It's going to roll up again. Trying to catch June Crable off guard. Into cover one. And a kick. Oh, roll back the other way. Look at it. Whoa. Yumiko Lee turned it back around. Jesus Christ. What a series of events between these two. These two know how to pop and roll up each other. Trust me. A little bit sneaky. Yumiko Lee. Got June Crable. Boom! Rams it with the steel stairs. And again right on in the back. Yumiko Lee not even going to worry about it. Whoa. Roll up by June Crable. Okay, look at this. This back and forth roll up. Quick pin. And a kick out at two. Try it as hard as you can. Yumiko Lee. Stuck on the ground. June Crable. What's the plan here? Crable. Got it with the throat. They're trying to go for another one. Another high kick. Crable on the outside, looking to capitalize. Oh, June Crable on the concrete. French kiss. June Crable into the quick cover on Yumiko Lee. Went to the three. What are you doing over there? Count of one. Count of two. I don't know why the referee's over there. Oh, he backed away again.
He got the best eyesight in the world.
I know, right?
The man can see through walls. He's kind of good, man.
June Crable. Oh! Oh man, with a steel chair, in the back of Yumiko Lee. Gee, another steel chair. Boom, another one. Oh no, Yumiko Lee's gonna move out of the way, but June able to catch her again. Cracked her on the head with the steel chair. This is brutal, another one. June Crable, no regrets whatsoever, and I don't blame her. This is an important match. Oh, here we go! Blue Thunderbomb headfirst under the steel chair. Under the steel chair. Dude, what about the steel chair? It's not the steel chair. June Crable, why is she not going for the cover? Ah! Dropkick right onto the table, the corner of it. Knees in the back! I don't know what she's striking down! Look at Yumiko Lee! Stuck in a horrible state of aggression by June Crable. June Crable got Yumiko Lee. Do we need a break from that? My lord. Taking Yumiko Lee off the concrete. Again, June Crable stomping down on her opponent, Yumiko. Boom! A super kick to the face! Yumiko, how should we back to her feet? Yumiko Lee caught back the other way. Incredible. Again, up top, running through. Able to flip her down. Now Yumiko caught! Camera guy by June Crable! Into the cover, trying to put a word to the referee. Oh! Where? Kick out! Where'd the referee go? I heard the camera, but I didn't see the referee.
He left the atmosphere.
Dude, my man is in the locker room chilling. June Crable.
He went to Jamaica.
Dude, Jesus Christ.
Wait, where is he? Oh, there he is. He came back. Knock him.
Oh, there he is. Referee was good.
He took a quick bathroom break.
Good lord. Oh my god. June Crable. Got Yumiko Lee up, taking her into the corner. Oh, what? You got to kind of think of it. Oh my god, what? Oh boy, she got it. Oh, yep. I expected exactly that. Yumiko Lee at the wolf. Whoa, my god. Jesus Christ. Fun fact about Junko. Oh my god, well, before we get to that, what a Jesus Christ, Junko. Whoa, that double left handle. Fun fact about June Quavo's finisher name, the Kamigoi, means God Killer. In case you didn't know. Just a little fun fact there. Oh, wait a minute.
Brian, speaking Japanese for 1 minute, I don't have that good.
I just looked it up.
Oh.
An elbow right to the shoulder. June Quavo, oh, went for the shot. Junko out of the window, right hand from behind. Junko lay from behind. German, don't crack. Oh, cracked under the rope. What in the world? It's ridiculous. Oh, we're back again. In the corner. Oh, wait a minute. Back the other way. Trying to go for the triple. Yumiko was ready for it with a kick. Doom wasn't ready for that one, though. The God Killer knee is what you could also call the Kamigoi, but I like to say the God Killer. That sounds better. Oh, what the hell? Yumiko well, got Yumiko Lee up. Got a play. Oh, whoa. Dropped over the top rope, I guess. Okay. Bye-bye. Oh, whoa. All right, I see you. A little bit of boasting from June Crable, the former women's champion. Staring down at Yumiko Lee over the top rope. Jesus Christ, how you land on her feet after that? June Crable got a steel chair ready in the back of Lee. Good lord. June Crable got her up yet again, June. Taking Yumiko Lee. Oh, went into the barricade, and another one into the barricade. Bounced off and took her again. Incredible, another one! Good lord! And a jab! Poor Yumiko, this one is getting clobbered on the barricade. Yumiko, take Dune into the barricade instead! Yumiko Lee, what is the plan here? The plan is intimidation, and waiting that right hand on the June Cradle. It's a sad day in the wrestling world, and these two are just beating the hell out of each other. It's sad to see. It's sad to see so much aggression between two women sometimes, I swear. Yumiko Lee. Oh! Through the barricade! Are you joking? I didn't even see it coming! Look at that! Question June Quavo through the barricade. Yumiko Lee trying to do everything in her power to get rid of Quavo. What are you gonna do? How are you gonna get up after that? I don't think June Quavo can barely stand. She can't even get up. He's struggling with itself. Yumiko Lee is going to bring him back to her feet. He slams her into the barricade. The aggression from Yumiko Lee coming out. The Spirit Wolf looking to put away and steal June Spirit at this point. Good lord. Yumiko Lee. Boom with a scoop slam. Yumiko again is just in deep trouble. Oh my god. Oh, well, she's back on her feet. But Yumiko is going to come back the other way. Yumiko Snapmare. Boom, my knee right to the spine. He's already damaged the core of June enough. Yumiko Lee standing over top of June Quavo like it's nothing. Yumiko Lee looking right at the face of June Quavo, trying to put the thing away now. 12 count, Eddie will remember that. June Quavo put back on the feet. The referee standing from the sideline. Shoulder block, able to take her down. Yumiko Lee looking for a new weapon, trying to keep her down and force her to be, oh my god, he got another candlestick. Boom, way to the chest. And another one to the chest. Look at her working on the core. June somehow able to get back to her feet. There's another strike from Yumiko Lee. Again and again. Yumiko. June back on her feet. Yumiko Lee trying to get it, but June gonna turn the tide. Incredible. Then he got a right to the gut. Another right to the gut. And a third. Incredible. Oh wait, we're taking Yumiko Lee back in the ring. Referee gonna follow right after. Look at the referee just diving in. He's a yell here. Oh, we're gonna elbow top of fireman carry.
I'm here.
Oh my god! Whoa! Went for the blast dunk from Yumiko Lee! No! June Quavo was ready for it! It would have been legal, but June was ready! Yumiko Lee trying to get her with the move! June was able to move out of the way! June trying to get her, trying to catch her again! No! Blue Thunder Bomb! Into the cover, caught off guard! Count of one! Count of two! That's it! June Quavo will beat Yumiko Lee! The momentum was there. I thought Yumiko Lee completely had that in the bag since the start of the match. But June Quavo proves all the odds wrong. June is still the better woman, and she will defeat Yumiko Lee at WrestleMania. What a brutal move that
she had. She had better, she had better stars than
Yumiko did. Yeah, that's true.
She did like all the damage in the way. If she didn't do that, if she didn't have damage, she would have lost.
That's what I was saying. The start of the match is the most important part of the match, and June Quavo to prove that right. June, who's the winner of Yumiko Lee?
to stay. Close the blinds, let's pretend that the time has changed. Keep our clothes on the floor, open up champagne. Let's continue tonight, come on, celebrate.
That's how we do.
Sometimes you gotta stay in. And you know where I live. Yeah, you know what we is. Sometimes you gotta stay in. Welcome to my house.
The following contest is an Iron Man match. It is for the All-Star Championship.
And our next match on the card tonight is one of the most anticipated matches yet. Kai versus Echo in a 30-minute Iron Man Extreme Rules Falls Count Anywhere match. Try to take all that in, I dare ya. It's for the Velocity Championship, of course, which Kai has held ever since the title round maybe when he first won it. He's been the only one to hold the Velocity Championship, and Kai is looking to retain it tonight, and Echo is looking to change that and become the champion for the first time ever. I very much hope that doesn't happen. Echo, he's got skills. He's a pretty good wrestler aside from all the cheating, but the cheating is what makes him a cheap shot and not wanted to win. That is pretty obvious, except for, you know, TPT, but he doesn't count. Everybody else hates Echo and wants Echo to win. Everybody else that isn't a simp will want Echo to lose. So let's hope that that's the case here tonight. Yeah, TTT. Yeah.
Hope you fall on your face.
Hope you fall on your face.
And then get up.
And then get up.
And then get up.
And then you get up. And then... and then you laugh.
And then you make sure you're alright.
And then you make sure you're alright because I don't... Okay, anyway. So here comes Kai making his way out to the ring for WrestleMania, baby. This is going to be very, very good. Like, how are these guys going to go for 30 minutes in an Extreme Rules match? That just doesn't seem right. Not to mention Falls Count... Oh! Not to mention Falls Count Anywhere and it's Iron Man. It's not like there's a 30-minute timer. And for the pin wins, you have to go for the full 30 minutes in order to complete the match. I mean, that is ridiculous. But Kai and Echo here tonight. If you don't shut your mouth, I'm going to actually stick a hammer down your throat and force you to...
Oh, yeah, but that's so good. Dude, hammers are really good. They don't ever taste the lead in the mouth. That's really bad. Anyways, let's start the match, right? Don't you think? Let's go.
Sheesh. At this point, I'm just gonna kill myself.
California, weighing in at 225 pounds. And introducing the champion from New York, weighing in at 225 pounds. He is the Thunderbolt, Key.
And here we go. This match is about to get underway. What? Match about to get underway. One of the most anticipated matches on the card here tonight. Echo versus Kai. Here we go. 30-minute Iron Man Falls Count Anywhere Extreme Rules match. It's hard to say. Jesus Christ.
But yeah, I'm sorry. Oh. I was kidding.
Oh, look at that booty, boy. Yo, okay. Seriously, don't ref move. WrestleMania is not the time to flex your butt cheek.
WrestleMania.
You know what? I'm not even gonna down you for that, because that was actually pretty good.
Aw, oh, thanks, man. Love you.
No, I hate you. Echo,
guys, wait, come on about this. Bonham never said I love you too. He is a really bad friend, right? If you think so, let's cancel him. Come on, cancel Ryan 2021.
I'm not the one that sat there on a promo and said that a woman belonged in a kitchen, even though I totally agree with him, but I did not convey that. It's a joke, guys. It's a joke. Don't cancel me. It's a joke.
Cancel me, though. Try.
Cancel him by canceling the flight board. Anyway, no. Seriously, back to the match. So. Echo versus Kai. All right. So we have 30 minutes to go. Or 29 minutes to go, excuse me. I can't read. Echo got Kai on the top rope. Up top. Boom! Put him down, goes Kai. And that's troublesome. Echo, oh no. Rolls to win. Get a cover, kind of. Ooh. I can't, man.
That's not reading. That's the number.
Well, you have to read a number to... Okay. Kai. Take an echo. What? Kai, take an echo off the rope. Trying to grab it. Kai, God, I'm pulling what I need right to the arm. Trying to wear him down, slowly but surely. Kai, with that...
Slowly but surely, Eric dies. Wait, no. I mean, Echo dies.
How do you get the two mixed up? You did that one time, too, at a Elimination Chamber.
They both have E.
Okay, so Emily just like, doesn't exist. Emily.
Emily got her head in the face.
Okay. Oh, whoa, what the oh. Fuck?
Yo, time travel.
Is there a camera up the face button? We're not gonna talk about that. One, and I kick out my echo. I'm like Alvin in the chipmunk. Oh, no, the food's not the right kind. I need to drink my hot chocolate. I'm not okay.
Fast though. Being fast. You're really fast.
You don't really choke on it. Oh. Kai's face buster. Dude, that's the third face buster in a row. What are you up to? Dude, your face. Man hit a face buster mark with the funniest thing he's ever seen.
No, because. This is, oh, what the?
Look, we're not even gonna fourth wall break. It's not okay. Kai with the leg drop. Echo now down on the ground. We're still waiting for a first pin. We're 3 minutes into this match. We're gonna do one with 5 minutes, so we got some time to go. What a knee right to the gut. Kai got Echo up. Kai up top. Bang! Land him down face first. These two have gone at it ever since the title pass pay-per-view, and are finally gonna get a conclusion here. By the way, this is the last time. Oh, good way in the carry. This is the last time Echo can ever compete for this title while Kai is holding it. Of course, if Kai loses, Echo can come back in contention, but... Oh, wait for the shooting star, but Echo got the knees up. What a chance for Kai, but Echo is not a scouted. But if Echo loses this match, he can no longer challenge for the championship while Kai is holding it. Oh, look at it. Submission move by Kai. Kai trying to tap out the chair. Look, he's tapping. Isn't that tapping? He's tapping his feet. That's the way he's tapping. He's not... Okay, I guess not. What the hell? Oh, God, wait, go there.
No, I think it was, whether or not.
Yeah, I mean, I would think so. You don't have to tap your hand. Oh, my God. I'm
I know, but what if
go
he was...
the carry.
What if he's trying to, like, have a fit?
Yeah, that's what I mean. You can tap his feet if you want to. But the referee is...
But he's like happy feet.
Oh my god. Count at two. Kick out at two just in time. I don't think he'd be happy feet by getting in a submission hold. I don't think anybody would be happy about that unless you're a
Massachusetts.
How do you pronounce Massachusetts? Yo, Michael, take a look. I'm gonna Google this while it's going on.
Okay, well, I mean, it's Massachusetts, Brian. It could be the English.
Oh, Kai's got a... Oh, God! Slam when I'm down! Look at that! Jesus Christ, the bat is one of the most deadly weapons in PCW. Kai, you're gonna throw it in the manager. You gotta let it in the back of the head. Whoa! Just in time, I can move it. Oh! God, dude, how would he still up on his feet? Echo, I think he's in a state of shock right now. I wouldn't be surprised. Oh, low blow by Echo. Completely illegal in this type of matchup. Echo, it's gonna come on Kai, please. One, two. Oh my God. Kai barely gets the shoulder up, but it's enough. Jesus Christ. Echo, what?
Echo.
I really
don't have to wait till the Echo guys perform.
Oh my god!
DDT simple Echo,
dude,
and
Echo
simple Echo.
Echo doesn't look like Emily at all to you. I don't know what you're talking about.
Echo. They're both god. White?
He's not even... Okay, he's a tan.
And they're both
back
Chinese.
Stutter! What? My fuck. No, oh my god! Kai with a kick out at the very end of two. Dude, you don't know how stressful that is. Even if it's just... I would say Echo wants to die, because if I was Echo, I would want to kill myself too.
Yeah, but so I would do about many would like score or Erica.
Well, score? Literally the human dumpling, okay? You look at him and go, he is the definition of the Family Guy tumor joke. Echo got the ladder, Kai down in the glass. Dude, laugh! That was funny! I was waiting for you to laugh, but it wasn't awkward.
Echo got the ladder!
Oh, so that was funnier than that joke, okay. Kick out right away by Kai!
Yeah, it was not gonna lie. Echo got the ladder.
So if I say something in a funny way, I'll be like, Ayo Marco, why did chicken cross the road? It got hit by a fucking car. And then I say, compared to, no, he got, oh, what a point, Michael, look what? Is that funnier to you, Michael?
Yeah, actually.
Oh my god. Okay, this is WrestleMania,
Echo,
we should not be doing
got the little. Dude, it's a tournament match, dude, okay?
I get it, but still, like, it's still, Echo would
okay.
Try.
I know, but it's a tournament match. I think we can have some funniness, okay?
So, black
what are you breaking? Then I will. Next.
Paul, I'm sorry, man. You gotta go. You don't exist.
Yeah, and definitely too.
Oh, spear! Oh my god! Spear to the middle rope, but oh my god! And I'm a shooting star! What the hell? Oh my god! Kai risking it all on the outside. He speared into the middle rope. Echo rolling out. Yeah, you can cover him. It's false count anywhere. Where was I? White people. Oh no, never mind. There, my guy is gonna cover. One, two, no, my god. Echo kicked out just in time. We're only 8.5 minutes, and we still don't have a pinfall. Good lord. Okay, white people, Michael.
You know, they like Trump.
I'm white, I don't like Trump.
Oh. Most are like Trump. No, those are two.
Mexicans? Wall.
They come from beans.
Mommy, how was I born? Well, there was a long process where I wanted a bean, right?
And then I thought, what the dog did? You know what I
mean? And the dog tried to eat you. Kai.
You know, everyone always asks what the dog. No one asks how.
I made that joke the other day in catchphrases. Insulting. You just stole
I know,
my
exactly.
joke.
Exactly.
Kai. Got Echo. Kai. With Echo. I'm a family with a ladder. Ow. My knee.
Wait, dude. Wait. It's telling me Kai didn't get why wouldn't Kai go in the ring and get a bat?
That's true. I don't know. The bat is definitely a deadly weapon.
I mean, it's not a stick.
Well, I mean, it kind of still kill her. Don't get me wrong, but...
Yeah, but yeah, but it's not metal.
Where the hell are they going?
They're leaving. They're leaving.
Oh, my God. Okay.
And the men need to be... They walk out of the same. Like, bye. What's that noise? Anyway, guys, we're gonna watch this epic. The Echo gets up. Kai had a table.
Yeah, I was
walking like he owned the place.
Oh!
Oh.
No, I was drinking hot chocolate when he hit that move, and I almost choked on my hot chocolate. Hot chocolate and WrestleMania, that's a good combo. Yo, you know what? I'm gonna make some popcorn when WrestleMania comes down. Fourth wall break, by the way. Yo, everyone in the chat, after this match, there's not a lot of break, but you know what, go get your snacks anyway. Yo, Paul,
no,
grab...
right now, do right now.
No, not right now. Paul,
no,
grab...
give me views.
Paul, get your... Paul, grab a bag of chips. If you don't have chips, then grab an apple. Grab an apple.
If you don't have an apple, then grab a woman. If you're not a woman, then grab yourself.
That doesn't sound okay. Kai got a table now.
That
sounds
kind of
sus. Whoa, my God. Okay, where was that? TCT, if you're here, TCT, I want you to...
To leave.
No! Stop being so mean to him.
I'm kidding, Eric. Eric, I was joking, okay?
I'm not a fire.
I was joking.
He was joking.
Sasuke, move.
Okay. TCT, I want you to...
Don't!
I want you to grab a granola bar. If you don't have a granola bar, then grab
grab grandma.
Grab your grandma. Alright.
If you don't grab one, then grab your
Yo, grab a grandma. Oh, wow! What? Emily, if you're here, I want you to grab
Nelson Mandela.
Who the fuck? Who? Nose Mandela. Oh, God, slam in the head right into this metal!
Ryan.
What? Little camera cannon? Oh, my God. What did you say, Fade? Nose Mandela.
Is it heavy metal?
No. What did you say before?
Is it heavy metal?
No, before that. I mean, it's metal, man. What does it matter? What did you say? I said, Emily, grab, and then you said, grab Jose Mandela?
Oh, grab Ryan and kiss him.
Yeah! Count of two! Oh! Did he kick? Oh, he got it! He got it! Kai with the fourth point of the match! Well, I think he got it. Did he get it? I think he got it.
I think so.
Kai with the fourth point of the match! On a possible roll-up. No, Kai! 13 minutes into the match. Okay, no, Emily, if you're here, I want... What the hell is Kai doing? Oh.
Emily, if you're here, I want you to go to Ryan's house and slap him in the walk away. Man. Marco, if you're watching this, then why are you watching this?
Why?
Go do your homework.
Oh, God! I think Kai took more damage. What did happen? I don't get it.
Kai took more damage. Dude, you're talking about damage.
Kai fell from behind. Dude, oh my God!
I became a joker.
Oh God.
But I'm not Eric, I'm not a clown.
God, bless you.
Oh. You got him too.
Yeah. Echo. Got Kai. Kai back. Hold on. Kai got Echo up. Hold on, I didn't sit. I fell out of my chair. Hold on. Echo got up. Oh, wait. Echo tapped out with his head. Okay, 2-0 Kai. No. Echo tapped out. Echo tapped out. Kai wanted to. Bear! Yes! And then a cover. 1-2. Yes! 3-0 Kai. This is exactly what I wanted to see. I'm happy. I fell out of my chair.
The moment you were happy?
Yeah! I fell out of my chair.
Let me more of that hand, Emily. I'm fine.
I don't forgive you. Roll up my ankle, roll up my ankle. Count of one. Count of two.
Two.
No! 3-1. Okay. Echo with a little bit of fight back. Echo now. We're almost at the halfway point of this match. 10 seconds till. Ah, nah! Another low blow. You gotta be joking. Come on, man. Oh my god. Come on, man.
Come on, man.
Kai up. Oh, Echo caught up with the knee. Poor Kai, man. Oh my lord.
Come on, man.
Oh. Try to go for the other knee by Echo to turn the back the other way. 14:40 remain. Echo got Kai back here. Oh, what the Christ. Echo got Kai up. Echo! Bang! Slam down face first. Echo beautifully done. Who's what with the hop of hand? What? Oh, no. Kai is up 3-1. Echo. Oh, no. Got him up. Echo. Echo. Got him! Back stunner. Shit. Echo. And then a couple of Kai. Come on, kick out a rope break. Beautiful. Okay, good enough. I'll take it. Echo taking Kai to the middle of the ring. And then a cover again. Going for another one. You running. One, two. Oh my god. What?
Yeah, you're like, I don't really. I
was having a seizure or a stroke. Echo got a ladder. Kai telling him no. Nice.
Echo got a ladder.
Echo with a sledgehammer riding into the gut of Kai. Still going down. That's what we got outside of the ring now. Roll by Kai. Cut the rat. One. Oh, kick out by Echo. Okay, kick out of one.
It was actually 3 seconds.
Don't think so. It was. It was
the
count.
It's harder to be black.
Okay.
I'm joking, Paul. Don't kill me. I know you're like a drug lord in like Zimbabwe. Okay.
What? Paul, we found you.
I wouldn't be surprised.
Got a table. Oh, okay. Yep.
Got a table.
He did have a table.
Hey Ryan, look. It's been 18 minutes. See, look how fast it flew.
17 minutes.
Time flies when you're a piece of crap winner.
Well, Marco, you must be at the speed of light.
I'm leaving.
Come on, that was good even if I didn't need it. Kai, back in the ring.
I know you mean it. I know what you think. Right now you're thinking of Hamburger.
I mean, not what I was thinking of, but it could be called that.
You're thinking of, oh, why didn't they
shoot? What? Uh-oh. Look at him. Oh, he's telling him to come on in. Kai, oh, it's a weapon. Look at it. They both have a weapon. Star Wars, baby. Oh, never mind. Kai, wrecked him on there with a bat. Oh, no. Echo goes back. How
Star Wars, baby.
Echo. Got Kai in the corner. Kai turns it around. Kai. Oh, no. Echo. Boom, a right hand. We're nearing the 10-minute mark of this match. We are nearing the end of this 30-minute Iron Man Falls Count Anywhere match. Kai slams him right on the ladder back first. Oh, Lord. Kai with Echo standing in the corner. Kai. Oh, my God. That's on the ladder. Uh-oh. Watch out. Here it comes. Drop kick. Oh, he suffered it, though. He had to land on the ladder to hit that. Good Lord. The dive down drop kick from Kai. Kai trying to roll through. Echo roll through the Echo. And trip up Kai. Face first under the table. Echo taking him out to the apron. Echo with the plan. Uh-oh. On the outside now. Still 3-1, by the way. Boom!
Yeah.
I don't have a back Echo. Echo with the plan. Echo taking Kai back in the ring. I don't know what the point of taking to the outside was then, but she can take him right back in. Look at the way there's a candlestick, a bat, a chair, a table, and a ladder. At least you thought
of
it.
And a referee.
And a referee. Whoa! That's a ladder. The ladder is being used a lot. I mean, I don't blame him, but Kai caught by Echo again. Echo with the plan here. Another kick to the back. He just keeps stomping on that back to Kai. Echo. Kai back on his feet now. Echo places him up. Got him again. He just keeps doing it. Boom! Slammed under the ladder. Oh, my lord, dude. Kai trying to roll out of the ring, but Echo gonna stop him in his track. With rolling track. Echo. Back up again. Jesus Christ, dude. Not again. Boom! Echo with a running powerbomb. I don't know what to think anymore. Echo using the ladder to advantage with make sense. I mean, it's not like it's illegal or anything. Oh, left hand by Kai. Kai trying to go back the other way. Now Kai, oh, we'll get back up square at all. And boom! Jesus! Oh, roll it by Kai, Count of one, count of two, and a kick out by Echo. Kai waiting patiently, trying to keep that momentum up.
Oh, that ladder is just some good judge to.
No kick. Whoa! Echo taking him over the top rope. Watch out. Echo got a steel chair. Oh, okay, he no longer has the steel chair. Echo, Michinoku driver! I don't know what Echo's plan was, to be honest with you. Picked up and then dropped it. I don't know if he was planning to do something to Kai or what, but I don't know. Echo, boom!
The plan is going to be to pick up it, he's gonna pick up a chair, hit him with it, then he's gonna land on the back, and he's gonna push him to the stick, hit him with it, that's gonna fly in the air, hit the chair, bounce off it, and hit him, hit Kai in the face,
This isn't Dragon Ball Z, this is PTW, Michael.
This is Dragon Ball Z, this is WWE, boom, boom, boom.
It's PTW, no, this ain't WWE, PTW.
It's PTW, PCW, more like PC.
Oh! Echo, you wanna finish that, Michael? My hand by Echo. Echo got him up with the knee at the Kai. Another knee to Kai. Dropped onto the ladder. Good lord.
But you want to finish that?
Oh, waiting for it. Echo angry at the ladder. And boom! Right to the back of the head.
I would be too. If I got hit by hitting.
Oh my god. Oh
if
no!
If I kept getting hit with it.
Oh no. You don't. Oh my god. No. On the ladder with the chair. No! Oh my god. It could have broken his foot. Kai is super lucky that his foot is snapped in half right now. The chair and the ladder are working together. Oh, no! Inverted crush by Echo. Not a good time. 3-1 Kai, but Echo is looking to make it 3-2. Echo, oh my god. No! Good play, Ezekiri! Looking to make it 3-2. Echo dragging Kai towards the middle of the ring. 7.5 minutes to go in the time, and 30 minutes walk in the Extreme Rules match. And then a cover. 1-2. Jesus Christ. 3-2. Kai back on his feet. Kai with only a 1-point lead right now. Uh-oh. Kai's got him up. Powerbomb. Recover. 1-2-3. That's another point. It's 4-2. There we go. I feel more comfortable now.
What happened when if they tie?
Oh, for the tie?
What happened? Yeah.
It's gonna go to sudden death. Fourth pin win. It's like overtime, basically, but... Echo setting up the table.
So basically...
Sudden death overtime, yeah.
I can't imagine!
Oh, off the roll. Okay. Echo
went
the wrong way. Taking it left. Echo.
He's taking it left.
Got Kai.
Put him on the monkey flick.
Oh my god. Oh, Kai gotta push him away. Kai, no, Echo goes back the other way. Okay, I really can't tell what's going on in there. What the fuck?
Blind.
I'm legally blind. Echo. Oh my god.
Legally blind.
Echo with the ladder. Oh no, you can't be thinking what I think you're thinking, right, Echo? Oh, I think you're thinking what I think you're thinking.
It's making my brain feel weird.
Oh my lord. It's time for the revenge! Throw the table with a knee! Kai did that to Echo with a... Dude, oh my god. Kai got caught up in the ladder. In the rope, I mean.
Kai started to levitate. He got the spit from within.
You seen that video of the guy that goes in the back and like, oh my god! Oh my god! That's what just happened to Kai, bro. Oh, no, wait a minute. 4-2 still, but Echo got him up, Echo! Here we go! Boom! Michinoku threw the ladder! I think Echo might have taken too much damage from that. Jesus, in a cover! Count of one, count of two! Oh, barely kicked out of it. What a close call.
Holy crap.
Oh my god!
Echo. Oh, that video!
Echo having the Kai. Oh, Echo with the ladder.
people watching this are probably really confused right now.
Dude, okay, Ryan, we played a video inside of a video, and then while they're watching a video.
Nah, I'll just let them be confused. Uh-oh, Echo got the ladder! Boom! Michinoku through the ladder into the cover of the world break!
Wait, he's inside the ladder.
No, he's not. What are you talking about?
He became the ladder.
What are you talking about? I don't see him here.
Echo! Oh, what the heck?
Back stunner! No! Don't, into the cover, Echo! One, two, damn it! 4-3! Kai leads by one again. Kai goes to a low punch, not gonna happen. We are, oh no, rolled by Echo! 4 minutes left! Count of one, count of two! Ooh, kicked out by Kai. This is an intense match. Somebody, they're not even finishers. They just roll each other up or whatever. Oh my god, no! No! Skullboy and the Gary from Echo! No. Oh, why did they go for cover? That's your mistake. That is your mistake. Kai off the rope. Kai. Oh, did nothing. Oh, what is the carry by Echo?
Kai is trying to talk to him.
Hey, how you doing? Echo, dragging Kai to the middle of the ring. What is the plan? Oh, well, it doesn't matter. Kai's up on his feet. Oh, my God. Oh, on the swim, but we barely missed. Kai trying to dodge him. Oh, no, look at it. Kai, good boy in the carry of his own. 3 minutes remain. Kai dragging Echo to the middle of the ring. Kai going for a quick cover on Echo. He's gonna have to put him away. Count of one. Count of two. And a kick out. 4-3 and still
really
the score. It's a signature. Don't worry.
No, but no, that was really ugly though. It's like a video too.
Yeah. Especially for all the stuff they've been through too, I guess though.
So. It happened 27 minutes.
Yeah.
And he kicked out at the beginning of two.
That is true. You know what? You're right. 2.5 minutes remain. Kai leads by one.
Pick up Kai. The chair.
With Echo back on his feet, Kai. Oh, neck breaker.
Never mind.
Kai, move walking. Taking Echo back.
Boom, boom, boom.
But for Gato, yeah, if he can just wear down Echo, if he can keep Echo down for the 2 minutes, he's going to win this match. But just keep him down. Don't even give him a chance of getting back into the match. Nah, just wearing him down a little bit.
I'm down, Gato.
Nah, you're fine. I thought it was a mission at first, too. Oh, Echo taking him back in the window. You can't do it if Echo's still fighting back. Echo. With Kai there. Third low blow of the match. Dude, Kai is literally not going to have children. I'm just telling you that right now.
He was never going to anyway.
It's
fine.
Kai is cool. He probably would.
I could afford the going to anyway.
Oh my god, I'm gonna cover on Kai. Kick out Kai, kick out Kai! No! 4-4! Shit, okay. 1.5 minutes remain. The 30-minute I am the match, and it's 4-4, ladies and gentlemen. Echo, oh! Kai goes back to the way. Kai trying to run through. Echo, turning it back with the clothesline. Christ, dude, this is, I don't like this. I actually feel tense from this. No. Echo, into the cover on Kai. Kick out. Come on. Count of two. No. 5-4, Echo. Oh, fuck. No. Echo with the lead. No, not again. Oh, never mind. Oh, I panicked so hard. Oh, you don't know how hard I just panicked. Echo with a 1-point lead all of a sudden. Kai was up 4-2. It's now 5-4. Marco like throwing a lead in Rocket League. Kick right to the back. Kai.
Wow.
I'm joking. I'm sorry. This should not be 30 seconds.
I'm sorry, man.
Dude, okay.
Fine. I'll be cute a little.
20 seconds. No, come on. No, come on. Echo, he's just trying to keep it up. 15 seconds. 10 seconds! Velocity Championship on the line, Kai! Returning back to the other way, 10 seconds! Bear! And then a cover on Echo, come on! Referee down, 1, 2, yes! 1 second and that's it! We are going to sudden death overtime! Oh shit! You don't know the panic that just went through my soul! Echo running through, not gonna happen, Kai! Turn them back to the other way with a cold line! The next pin will win the Velocity Championship. Kai looking to retain. Echo looking to win it for the first time. Trying to go for it. Echo goes back the other way with all that pin. These men have beaten the absolute hell out of each other for so long. Kai trims them up. Down goes Echo.
Kai, the champ trying to spin it. Echo, no! No! Echo! No, 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 no! Backpack stunner! Shit! Come on! Count of one! Count of two! Yes! Kai, I'm gonna kick out! Oh, shit. Kai, somehow...
You know you can breathe, right?
I can't, dude. I can't do it.
You're not good for it.
Kai, got him with the gun punch. Another gun punch. Echo against the wall. Kai, taking him off the wall. Again, Echo in trouble. Kai, backing him off the wall. Bam! Kai, come on! Into the cover on Echo! One, two, yes! Oh my fuck. Oh my god. I'm so tense. Kai, at the brink of it, dude. Kai retains against Echo. I don't even know how it was possible at that point. Echo with the 5-4 lead. Kai with 10 seconds able to spear him and win it. And then they get the sudden death and win the match. Velocity champion. Kai still holds it. He has not lost it. But the title draft came, but he still has not. The winner of this WrestleMania match. It's Kai, baby. Thank the Lord. Tonight's next match on the card is a one-on-one contest for the Women's Championship. Crazy Daisy coming out first. The Flower Girl looking to make history here tonight at WrestleMania. Crazy Daisy, the winner of the Royal Rumble from the number one spot. The former Velocity Takeover Women's Champion is going to square off against Nancy Grable inside the square circle here tonight. Crazy Daisy, not a lot of momentum going into this match. She's going to have to use that drive to win. To be able to get her momentum up enough to even beat Nancy Grable. I mean, Nancy Grable is a great superstar, obviously, and Gracie Daisy is going to have to find a way to take her down once and for all here at WrestleMania. And here comes the women's champion, looking to defend again, one of the top stars and the biggest rising star, arguably, in the women's division, Gracie Daisy. Nancy Grable trying to take down, I guess you could call her a rival at this point. Here comes Nancy Grable!
Dante Cuervo and Gracie Davis had a lot of momentum going through these past couple of weeks ever since Gracie did the Wonder Royal Rumble. And then, of course, Dante Cuervo actually cashed in on Madison Ivy at the Royal Rumble 2 to win the Women's Championship. And, of course, Gracie Davis interviewed three people. She interviewed Nancy, she interviewed Forgetti, and she interviewed Flutter Byfoot. And when she interviewed Nancy, something went wrong, and Dante Cuervo felt the need to ruin her matches over and over again. So Nancy Cuervo, definitely not the good guy here, but she is looking to defend here tonight against a rising star in Gracie Davies.
Introducing the challenger from the United Kingdom, Grace. And introducing the champion from Charlottesville, Virginia, she is the
And here we go! Without any further ado, the Women's Championship match about to get underway. WrestleMania hosting these two great superstars. Referee rings the bell. It's time to get it underway. Daisy taking Nancy Cuervo into the corner. This is Gracie Daisy's biggest match of her entire career. And she's looking to make it count here at the big show. The biggest night of the year, biggest night of the year. This is night one, and Gracie Daisy trying to make history. Daisy's. Boom! A dragon screw! Nancy Cuervo goes flat on her back. Gracie Daisy now got Nancy Cuervo back on her feet. Daisy locking up with the women's champion. Nancy Cuervo defending here tonight is definitely the more likely option considering how good Nancy Cuervo really is. But Gracie Daisy is going to try her hardest and try, well, I guess you could call it an upset. It won't be upsetting for anybody, but it'll be classified as an upset. Not exactly a David vs. Goliath story compared to maybe Bond vs. Benjamin, if that was ever a match. But David vs. Goliath a little bit here because Nancy Cuervo definitely the more experienced wrestler. And obviously she's the women's champion compared to Gracie Daisy not having a title. A former Velocity Takeover women's champion with Nancy Cuervo cost her and she lost to Mel Young. I kind of started this whole rivalry, sparked it, and Gracie Daisy ever since has not been happy with Nancy Cuervo. Nancy Cuervo has been that one cocky superstar. Oh, I can win this match. Oh, you're not, you don't stand a chance. You know, I'm the best. I'm the best women's champion, blah, blah, blah. But of course, as we know it, Gracie Daisy definitely does not have the edge here tonight. I'll say that. But she has a chance. Everybody has a chance. Gracie Daisy trying to push away Nancy Cuervo. The match is just starting to heat up now. Gracie Daisy taking Nancy Cuervo into the corner. Daisy looking for the retaliation. Gracie Daisy stomping down in the corner. Nancy Cuervo. Nancy's going to move back out of the way. Cuervo backing up. Drop kick to the back of the head. Gracie Daisy not in a good position now, trying to find a way to strike back against Nancy Cuervo in a tough, tough match. Daisy without the rope. Nancy Cuervo turns her around. DDT right to the top of the head. Possibly kick though. Gracie Daisy able to get back to a few close calls, but Nancy Cuervo. Gracie Daisy from behind. Oh, no. Gracie sent over the top rope to the apron. Oh, a shoulder block by Cuervo all the way to the outside. Nancy Cuervo heading to the top rope. What is Nancy looking for up high? Oh, my God. Oh! Feet first on the Nancy, on the Gracie Daisy. She didn't even try to do a body flash or nothing. She just wanted to land a hard car, land your ankles, your knees on Nancy Cuervo's plate, or Gracie Daisy's plate. You already know that's going to be painful. Striking down on the flower girl. Trying to get away. Oh, look at her. She's trying to... What is she trying to do? Oh, with a knee right into the announce table. Nancy Cuervo rules with aggression. Here at this WrestleMania match, the challenger is in trouble. Daisy cannot seem to fight back. These are the first time these guys are actually fighting one-on-one. Their first ever match together. And Nancy Cuervo seems to have the edge here. Nancy Cuervo off the springboard! Tanked with a splash to the back of Gracie Daisy! Good lord. Oh, and Nancy Daisy able to get back to her feet, able to thrust the feet into the face of Nancy Cuervo. Gracie Daisy trying to struggle her back to her feet.
day, the roundhouse, but no, Nancy Quaybo blocked it. Nancy Quaybo got her up head to the DDT right into the mat. And then a cover, referee's gonna count one, two, and a kick out by Gracie Daisy. Head to the DDT, the move that cost Gracie Daisy the match against Dolly Cook. Now getting back to her feet, Nancy Quaybo looking for a big move. Oh, wait for the looming pulse strike, but look at that. Gracie Daisy count, and that one did a chop. Daisy with the momentum flying back her direction. Boom, a knee right to Nancy Quaybo. Gracie Daisy with a huge opening, headed to the top rope. Nancy in trouble. Gracie, whoa, wait for the swanton. But Nancy Quaybo able to get the knees up. The momentum was flowing for Gracie Daisy. Just a tentacle. Oh, whoa. Watch out now. He died at just, oh, wait for a kick. Nancy turned it back the other way. Wheelbarrow Thunder got her. What about a chaos going back and forth? Lots of, I mean, these guys got each other scouted out pretty big time at this point. Nancy Quaybo trying to get Gracie back to her feet here. Nancy Quaybo on the outside. Quaybo on the springboard. Springboard dropkick connect to Gracie Daisy. Daisy not in a good way now. Daisy looked completely out of it. Nancy Quaybo trying to go for something. Trying to go for field of glow. But Gracie Daisy going to turn it back. To the outside. Trying to attack on Nancy. Nancy makes the first strike. They'll take Gracie back in the ring. Nancy Quaybo taking a second outside of the ring now. Nancy back in, Nancy Quaybo looking for something, but Gracie gonna meet her inside with an Irish whip. Gracie Daisy, what's the plan now? Gotta Nancy Quaybo into the corner position. Ooh! And he turned it back the other way. Nancy shoving Gracie Daisy into the opposite corner. Gracie gonna fight back the other way, though. Gracie Daisy trying to fight again, but Nancy Quaybo able to get out of that one. Nancy Quaybo a jab. And a kicker into the corner. Gracie goes back with an elbow. Daisy now into the chops again, trying to catch Nancy Quaybo off guard. Off the road, coming through, wait for the knee, but Nancy Quaybo able to move out of the way just in time. Nancy Quaybo now taking Gracie into the corner. These two women already tiring each other out, no problem with it. Nancy Quaybo jumping off, Nancy Quaybo hitting 450. Beautifully done by the women's champion, and she's looking to defend here tonight against the biggest rising star of the company right now, honestly, in my opinion, I think. Honestly, it might even be a fact at this point. Gracie Daisy, though, fighting back the other way. Got her just go. Oh, Nancy gonna take her over the top rope to the outside. Quaybo looking for some leeway for herself here. Nancy Quaybo, taking her into the ring. Quaybo looking for a position now. Quaybo got her on her feet. Nancy Quaybo taking Gracie off the rope. Quaybo taking her into the corner now, redirecting her. Quaybo's got a plan and looking to execute it, but Gracie Daisy turned it back the other way, trying to go for something from behind. Nancy gonna go for one of her own. Nancy Quaybo from behind. Nancy Quaybo. Ah, oh, looping palm strike. Nancy Quaybo out of nowhere with a looping palm strike into the cover. Oh my God! Gracie Daisy powers out at one. What in the world? Nancy Quaybo can't seem to believe it. Neither can I. Gracie Daisy got the shoulder up at the count of one off the looping palm strike. The heart and the soul of Gracie Daisy trying to stay in this match from Nancy Quaybo. It's looking like she's overpowering her in every category. Daisy trying to go through. I don't know if Daisy can keep up with Nancy Quaybo anymore. Nancy Quaybo coming out the springboard. Dropkick connects to the challenger. Gracie Daisy in a horrible position. I don't think she can keep up with Nancy Quaybo. I don't think she can. A kick out at two just barely. Gracie back to her feet trying to get away from Nancy Quaybo. Boom! Kick right to the side of the head and Gracie Daisy. But Nancy Quaybo trying to keep the feet of Gracie on the outside. Oh, Nancy head back in. Daisy, oh, a call from behind. Quaybo keeps on striking, getting away on Gracie Daisy. Nancy Quaybo, look at that strike over and over again. There's a kick right to the side of the head, but Gracie trying to fight back, got her in the gut. Gracie, a high kick, trying to fight back against the champion. Definitely being overpowered throughout this match, definitely being the least likely to win it. But Gracie Daisy's trying to give it her all. Oh my God, Daisy off the rope. Daisy running through it with a spear through the rope. Daisy with a match-turning move at this point, honestly, yeah. Spear through the rope. Look at that. Right through the gut of Nancy Quaybo, and that may be the turning point of the match for Gracie Daisy.
Doesn't matter if you get caught up in the ropes or not, that move was still devastating, even if you weren't. Gracie Daly mustering Nancy back into the ring. Gracie, what's the plan? Daly heading to the top rope, trying to use her energy to get her. Daly! Swanton Bomb! Connects to Nancy Grable! Gracie goes for the cover! Rolling up the leg! Nancy in trouble! Count of one, count of two, but Nancy able to power out somehow! Such a close call! Nancy Grable still your women's champion as this match is continuing on. Daisy again to the top rope. Daisy looking for another one. Oh, wow! Out of midair! What are you doing? Roundhouse kick out of midair! You gotta be kidding me! Count of two! No! Gracie with the shoulder up at the last second. I can't even process what's happening. Gracie was going for another swanton and Nancy made sure to make her pay for it. The experience is definitely in favor of Nancy Grable. Elbow there by Gracie Daly though. Daisy trying to find a way to fight back. Daisy, right hand takes down Nancy Grable. Now Daisy up the Grable shooting star! Who next full force? Gracie Daly, in a world of trouble, but she is trying to do everything she possibly can to take down Nancy Grable. I really hope she got it. Oh, my name, my Nancy, Gracie Daly to Nancy Grable. I can't even process it. Into the barricade. Daisy, what is the plan now? Count of four. Daisy got her positioned on the barricade. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Oh my god, Daisy on the apron. Yes! Come on, Gracie! Daisy takes the round with a spinning leg drop on the barricade! Gracie Daisy, another turning point in the match. Nancy Grable in a world of trouble now. The tides are turning. Daisy already defying all the odds. The first time she did that was at the Royal Rumble, winning for the number one spot. The second time was beating Mel Young. The third time was beating Mel Young for the championship. Instead, at TakeOver. And then a cover trying to put her away. Nancy got a power out right away. And we're looking for a fourth time at WrestleMania. The Gracie Daly has been known to defy all the odds. And she's looking to do it again here tonight. Leg sweep is an octopus stretch on Nancy Grable. And a rope break is able to save Nancy. Grable barely able to escape that submission move. One of the more deadly on the roster, I can tell you that. Boom, a clothesline. Daisy now again heading to the top rope. Daisy maybe looking for another swanton bomb. Daisy will not have it. Swanton, but no. Nancy able to get the knees up. Instead turning into a backbreaker, I guess you could say. And now Nancy Grable heads in the DDT into the mat. Maybe looking for the finish. Nancy Grable with Gracie Daisy in her sights, looking up. Daisy in trouble. Nancy Grable. No. Daisy turns it back around. What is she doing? Gracie Daisy stuck in the corner by Nancy Grable, able to dodge the looming palm fake to spare the oh, Daisy turns it around. Gracie went into the clothesline. Another one takes on Nancy Grable. Dodging under. Thumber kick to the face. Daisy looking for the opening she's needed. Nancy Grable, the power of the back to her feet. Trying to go for it. Gracie able to roll out of the window. Gracie back in the ring. Nancy Grable trying to thrive. Gracie turns it back around. Gracie trying to go for the shot, but Nancy turns around with an Nancy carry. Right to the back of the head. Nancy Grable running through trips around. Nancy Grable full force and doing absolutely everything she can. But Nancy Grable seems to still be on top. Oh, yeah. Jab by Gracie Daisy. Now Daisy goes to her right. Nancy Grable will turn the back around. Nancy Grable, Northern Light Suplex. Oh my god, that's not it. Nancy Grable! Wah! Nancy Grable with an opening, headed to the top rope now. What is Nancy looking for? Nancy, a shooting star, but got the knees up right to the face. Gracie Daisy knees right to the face. A jab by Daisy, trying to get her down. A high kick. Daisy from behind. Neck breaker to the champion. Daisy kick to the gut, trying to find a way, find an opening to catch Nancy Cable off guard. Look at this, stretching the arms against the wall, trying to take her down for the looping palm strike. She needs a lot of power in that arm to make the looping palm strike effective. If Gracie Daisy can take that out, she's got a chance. Daisy locking up the arms. Look at that, Nancy Cable in trouble. Look at that. Lever pull, you guys can say. Which one? Lever pull? Sure. Daisy slowly but surely working her down here. Strike after strike, a roundhouse. Nancy Cable goes down. And an elbow piercing the side. Daisy has got everything in her favor right now. You gotta capitalize on it, Daisy. Go, go, go! You got your moment. Use it. Capitalize. Throw him a clothesline to take down Nancy. You got everything she needs to put this match away. She needs to find a way to do it. Come on, Gracie. Come on, Gracie. Keeps on jamming away at the champion. Daisy keeps on striking. Nancy keeps on falling. Gracie Daisy won't let her go. Nancy Cravello back to her feet. Trying to get her up. Daisy mustering every little last bit of energy she's got. Oh, Nancy, a dropkick from behind as she escaped off the ropes. Gracie had the momentum, but Nancy. And Gracie Daisy. Oh, Gracie hitting the chop. Here we go. Daisy coming off the roof. Nancy caught with an A. Gracie Daisy got the opening now. Finish it. Daisy to the top rope. Put it away. Come on, Gracie. Come on, Gracie. Stop wasting your time. It's time, baby. Gracie. One top bomb. He's going to cover. Two. Yay. Gracie Daisy. You gotta be joking me! The one who defies all the odds has done it again at WrestleMania! Nancy Cravel talking all that trash, talking all big game, and Gracie Daisy puts an end to it, defies the odds, and makes sure to put all the hate of the way. Gracie Daisy is your new women's champion! The biggest win of her career, and probably the best moment of WrestleMania we've seen yet. Gracie Daisy, your new women's champion, much deservedly so.
Falling.
Oh, between the Bradley Buchanan and Orion Yokozuna, the Akihiro and Buchanan. So, this is for the Velocity Takeover Championship, of course. Why would it not be? Pretty obvious at the point. But it's going to be interesting to see what goes down because Bradley has been getting better and better, and he's gotten a face a couple times. So, the Akihiro taking on the Raging Flame here at WrestleMania.
And here we go. Here come the Velocity Takeover Champion trying to defend his title here tonight. The Akihiro, the one and only, the most charismatic man in arguably all of BTW. It's time to get this underway. One of the best of all time in BTW. Here come the Akihiro, Ryan Yokozu.
Introducing the challenger from Montgomery, Alabama, weighing in at 220 pounds. And introducing the champion from Tokyo, Japan, weighing in at 225 pounds. He is the Ryan
back.
Here we go. This match about to get underway for the Velocity Takeover Championship. Ryan Yokozu with the Blandy Butcher and the referee. Here we go. And Yokozu, whoa! Butcher and running right through the clothesline, taking out Yokozu. And Butcher is looking to start off aggressive here in this match.
the Bradley. Oh, a knee and ragdolled him right down. The Bradley Boots and then darted off dominant in its one match against Jacoby. And Evolution, Jesus Christ. But Jacoby came back and won it, so I would not be surprised if Jacoby did the same thing here at WrestleMania. With a chop and a right hand, Boots and it was caught. Jacoby, notably dominant for most of his matches, which is the interesting part about Boots and it. And Boots and it was able to dominate for an amount of time, but Jacoby always finds a way to fight back. And Jacoby, to Bradley Boots and it. In the corner now, Jacoby. Whoa! Jacoby was hooking him up in the corner. Jesus Christ.
Smell my food.
Oh, Jacoby in the corner. Strong style knee strike.
Knee winder.
Jacoby. Jacoby, one of the most charismatic and loved men in all of PCW, and you can kind of see why at this point.
Loved men.
Yeah, one of the most loved men.
Everyone loves his men.
In a no homo way, you nutbag. Oh! Glad that you
didn't know. I've been called a. What are they called? Like a bald head?
Oh,
a shiny forehead?
I wonder why. I wonder who that was from.
Paul?
Oh, yeah. I was okay.
Yeah, thanks, Paul. Stupid.
Oh. Nah, Paul is.
Yeah.
Kick right there.
No, I would literally beat up Paul when I'm like 8'2".
Paul's like, yeah, okay, I was gonna say. Oh, whoa, your code is German! Duplex to Bradley, Jesus Christ. Bradley had a
what?
What are you doing? Oh, yeah, well, that's your mistake. Why would you go to the top rope with the code standing? I mean, that's kind of a rookie mistake. Cody with Bradley pushing it back on his feet. Even in the back of the way with the left hand. Ba-dee-da-dee-da! Never mind, wrong song. And Cody, oh! Come with a splash like a Bradley off the springboard! Jesus Christ. Nah, he got it. Right on the side. Cody caught with the right hand. The Bradley another right. The Bradley a third right. Now Bradley! Woo! Neckbreaker to Ryan to Cody. The Bradley got him up. Bang! Kick right to the back. The Bradley Boots in. Got Jacoby taking him off the ropes now. The Bradley Boots in. Oh, what the hell? Goes to a right, caught him again at the left. The Bradley, the wolf got stopped. Off the turnbuckle, Boots in. Up top, here we go! Bang-a-ring! Also, I like Jacoby's gear. The red gear.
I like your cut, Jeep.
The Bradley Boots in. A right hand. Oh, no! Here we go! Cutthroat side slam! The first one of the match into the cover. Count of one. Count of two! Woo. I expected a kick out, but I was a little late.
I was
able to kick out at two of the cutthroat side slam. Oh, right hand. Spinning kick will not go. Jacoby turns it back to the way. Oh, here we go! Kinshasa! Kinshasa by Jacoby into the cover. One, two, ooh! Boots and powered out at two. Jacoby, though, that's going to do a lot of damage to that man, trust me.
Kick right to the back. Damage.
That's a lot of damage. Oh, whoa, what's the kick? But Boots ain't able to get him right back on. Jacoby, oh no, caught again. Jacoby goes back the other way. Jacoby, oh, here we go again! Kinshasa! Into the cover on Boots, count of one. Count of two. And a kick out by Boots and again, 2.5, just like last time. Boots wow. Not kicking out, not really kicking out significantly earlier, but it's earlier than people
whoa,
thought.
Whoa, his legs are kind of sus.
What?
Legs are like open.
Man, you got them driving. Oh, running through Jacoby. With a cold run, another cold run. Yeah. Jacoby, super kick to Boots. What did I do?
You, my friend.
Boots and then watch out. Here comes Jacoby. Starting up with a strong style knee strike. Jesus Christ. Jacoby rolling him over into the cover on Boots and off the knee strike. Count of one. Oh, kick out at one. Oof. Boots and then still able to maintain his relevancy in this match so far, surprisingly. Because he gets the double. Still have a weapon to kick shot from Boots and moves out of the way. Boots and then got him by the throat. Good lord. Boots and then blow. Oh, my God.
Dude, that was like a Ryu.
You know how strong you have to be to go for a gut punch and have somebody be lifted up by it? Oh no! Oh no! Bang-o-rang!
Are they in the same heavy division? And like last division?
What?
Like, are they both heavyweight? Or middleweight? I don't know.
Oh, no! Knuckles, no! Knuckles definitely a heavyweight. I don't know what Yokozu is. I think it's a light or heavyweight. What did it do? Oh, my God. Yokozu is either one weight class under or he's the same weight class. One of the two.
Because he's one
guy. Probably. Richard is super strong, too. I mean, that's obvious. Running through.
And he's black.
That's not what I meant. Oh! Flying through the clothesline.
He's been around the block a couple times.
He grew up in Dahood.
He grew up in Rahul.
He grew up in Rahul. I mean, he is pretty fat. Boom! Dropkick right to that groin. Ah! Is that legal? I don't think that's legal. Why is the referee not calling for the belt? That's basically a low blow, right?
No.
Yeah. Dropkick right to the fucking balls. I think that's a pretty low blow.
I don't think they saw it then.
Probably not. Oh, Buchanan trying to wear him out with a cross face. Oh, wearing him down. Boom. Buchanan looking to capitalize now, telling him to stay down. Buchanan. Kick right to the back of the neck. Uh-oh. That's why you should have stayed down. Stay down, Yokozu. Stay down. Buchanan. Knee strike. Boom. A BFT. Buchanan looking to put this thing away right here, right now. In trouble. On its feet. Don't get up, Yokozu. Buchanan now. Turn it back the other way. Here we go, baby. Oh, boom. Right hand up top. Got him up. Inverted power slam. That is what I love to see. Uh-oh. Up top now. Whoa. No, never mind. I thought it was going for something. A right hand. Jesus Christ. Buchanan caught again. Yokozu. What's the plan here? Yokozu got it against the rope. What are you going to say?
Jesus Christ.
Ooh. What?
Jesus Christ is my...
Not playing it. Oh, Yokozu! Yeah! Come on! Yokozu steady up, Yokozu steady up. Come on, baby. Hit it! Coming through! Kinshasa! Into the cover! One!
No.
Two!
Dos.
Oh my God!
You get one on your alphabet. Uno, dos, tres.
Kick out at two again. Somehow, some way, chopped by Yokozu, taking him into the corner. Buchanan in a little bit of trouble. Yokozu, what's the plan here? Yokozu taking him to the top rope. Yokozu rolling through. Yokozu running in with a knee right to Buchanan. Good lord. So skilled, so amazing with the in-ring skills. Yokozu on the middle rope now, telling him to get up. Get up, Buchanan. Yokozu setting up for something on the middle rope. Yokozu on the middle rope. Coming through! Ah! Kinshasa! From off the middle rope! What a unique move! Into the cover! One! Two! Ryan Yokozu is still your Velocity Takeover Champion! Oh my God! Buchanan gave it his all, but the Akihiro will still be the champion of PCW! Honestly, I don't care. I know Kai is a lot of him, but I feel like Yokozu is my main champion. Look at this man. Still retains one of the most dominant men. He hasn't lost a match yet. I want to point that out. Yokozu, one of the best of all time so far in PCW. I want to see him go to the main roster because this is going to be interesting. Yokozu is still the Velocity Takeover Champion.
Sometimes you gotta stay in, and you know where I live.
And here we go, continuing on with WrestleMania. We have a triple threat match for the Velocity Women Championship. And this is Nevaeh Lee Hanna coming out first. One of the three competitors that are most likely to win it, in my opinion.
The following contest is a triple threat match. It is for the All-Star Women's Championship. Introducing the challenger, from Toronto, Ontario, Canada, Mexico, Nevaeh Lee Hanna.
Nevaeh Lee Hanna, arguably one of the best superstars in Velocity, if not the best women superstar we have right now. What of I thought is great, but I mean, let's be honest, it's really better than Nevaeh Lee Hanna. Nevaeh has not lost a match since her return a long, long time ago, and she hasn't even gotten close to losing a match. Byford's had a lot of competitors, and Angelica Lopez especially, and not even Angelica. I mean, Angelica even beat her. Yeah, it was cheating, but to be fair, Angelica beat Byford clean the other week, and Nevaeh has been destroying Angelica. Now I have to wonder, is Nevaeh Lee Hanna the best one? I mean, I guess by triple threat rules, anything can happen. It's not like you have to pin Nevaeh or pin Byford to win it, but here comes Angelica Lopez, entrant number two here at WrestleMania.
And introducing the challenger, representing High Voltage, from Indianapolis, Indiana, Angela Lopez!
Angelica Lopez beat Flutter Byford clean at Velocity Takeover Sabotage. Now you have to wonder, does Angelica Lopez have what it takes to come back and be the new Velocity Women's Champion? I guess two times, because she did win it once before. That was a long, long time ago. The question is, can she do it again here at WrestleMania? The history between those two superstars, Byford and Angelica, are through the roof, and now with Nevaeh being a new entrant here. But here comes the champion, Flutter Byford, the Velocity Women's Champion, looking to defend tonight in the biggest match of her career, biggest match of all their careers. Here is Flutter Byford. Look at the rainbow on her tonight. Special gear for a special occasion. Let's see what she can do.
Introducing the champion, from Erie, Pennsylvania, she is the
Flutter Byford here tonight looking to defend. It's honestly going to be a hard pass because, of course, she has been beaten by Angelica Lopez. And Nevaeh Lopez, Nevaeh Lee Hanna, excuse me, has destroyed Angelica Lopez on the other hand. So if we're ranking it by list, by right now, it's Byford, then Angelica, then Nevaeh. I don't want to say worst to best because none of them are bad superstars, but I guess if we're ranking it that way, that's just what it seems like right now. Because Angelica has beaten Byford. I said that again. So you have to wonder, does Byford have what it takes to be able to retain her championship here tonight with all odds to fight against her? He's done it before to title draft taking you against Angelica, so who knows? Maybe Byford does have what it takes. And here we go, without any further ado, Byford versus Angelica versus Nevaeh for the Velocity Women's Championship. Here we go, we're starting out the match. Angelica Lopez gonna go right after Byford, and oh, Nevaeh out of nowhere with a clothesline taken out. Oh, Angelica Lopez, look at this, and a shin breaker than a champion. This is going to be a hard and brutal match, E3. Oh my god, look at Nevaeh, what is that? Good lord. Nevaeh pulling out new moves. Oh my god, tossing Byford across the ring, head first into the turnbuckle. Angelica from behind, Nevaeh Lee Hanna, I gotta turn it around. This may be one of the most brutal matches we have seen at WrestleMania so far, considering who's in this match. Angelica and Nevaeh are two very, very, very physical superstars. They're improving that right here, right now, to begin to get this match, and a backbreaker by Byford to Angelica Lopez. And then Nevaeh running through, trying to trip her up. Oh my goodness, don't know what happened there. Nevaeh Lee Hanna piercing a knee into the side of Byford. Watch out, Nevaeh tripped up Angelica Lopez, and two are alone in the ring as Byford had to roll out. Look at this, cranking the foot of Angelica Lopez. Nevaeh Lee Hanna trying to fully work on the joints of both of her challengers. Oh, I got the champion and the challenger here tonight. She is one of them. Here's Byford back in the ring, but look at this. She's gonna take her side away. Oh my goodness! stomping on the hand of Angelica Lopez and the Bailey Hannah. Right from behind, tried to go for Lita Nevaeh, caught it, DDT to my flood. Nevaeh Lee Hannah ever so dominant at the start of this match, cranking the neck, almost broke it. Good God. Oh, now I'm going to do the same to Angelica Lopez. Little by little, these guys, or these women, are absolutely tearing each other apart. We're only a few minutes into this match. Nevaeh Lee Hannah got Angelica slamming her face into the turnbuckle over and over again. 10 times into the turnbuckle, knocks Angelica clean out. Had to go for a fifth. Byfuck gonna catch her though, flutter by flood. Got her up and a duplex connect in the veil. He hit her. Byfuck looking to get some leeway here. Byfuck got her up in the veil. Gonna turn it back the other way. Bailey Hannah really proving out here, but look at this, Angelica from behind takes her down with a beautiful suplex. Dragging Nevaeh towards the middle of the ring, Byfuck waiting on the sideline. Angelica stomped to the arm of Nevaeh. Trying to take out Byfuck, but Byfuck moved out of the way, turning it back the other way. Nevaeh outside of the ring, it's just Byfuck and Angelica alone in the ring. Two rivals to day one. Oh, Angelica caught with the Hurricane Runner. By far beautiful athletic with Nevaeh Lee Hannah though, back in the ring now. And did a cover. Count of one. And Nevaeh gonna break things up. Lee Hannah punch! Oh my God! By far across the ring. Nevaeh Lee Hannah, oh, rolling into a triangle arm bar! Trying to tap out the champion here at WrestleMania! Oh, look at Byfuck though. Byfuck able to get out of it. Lucky for her, that could have been brutal. Angelica Lopez, Hurricane Rana to Nevaeh Lee Hannah. Angelica Lopez now trying to clothesline Byfuck, but Byfuck backing out of the way. Angelica though not letting up. Angelica trying to go for the strike, Byfuck out of the way again. Byfuck with the plan here, they're kind of looking at each other now. Angelica tried to go for the strike, get there that time. Byfuck was staying out of the way of her attack, but Angelica finally called him. Byfuck was out of the way, trying to strike down on Nevaeh Lee Hannah, but Nevaeh goes back the other way. A clothesline rock in the face. Oh, Angelica Lopez. Brutal and merciless. Oh! Shoulder block into the corner to Nevaeh Lee Hannah! Oh my God! Oh, what a shoulder taped out! Angelica Lopez on the hill. Oh my God, Lee Hannah did a top roll looking to fly! Boom! Elbow drop to Angelica! Byfuck now back in the ring out of nowhere. Byfuck trying to go after Nevaeh Lee Hannah now. Nevaeh fears nobody. How? Is anybody going to be able to take her down? Never mind! Exploder! Suplex in the corner! Byfuck catches Nevaeh! Byfuck maybe looking for a close finish now, trying to take down at least one of these two superstars. What is Byfuck going to do? Oh, whoa, whoa! Angelica trying to steal the cover! Look at her! Trying to be sneaky like that. Byfuck caught her full force though. Byfuck trying to attack on Angelica Lopez, is slowly getting back to her feet. Oh, trying to go for a kick to Byfuck, but Byfuck didn't want to move out of the way. Angelica Lopez taking off the wall. Byfuck coming in with a belly to belly connect. Trying to go for the cover, but in the belly hit her back to her feet, breaks up the pin. And a Hurricane Rana. Byfuck looking to, oh, there goes the way again. It's going to be Byfuck and Angelica alone again. Now Byfuck's got an opportunity. Byfuck make it count, headed at a top roll flutter. Byfuck looking to fly, got her with the senton. And then a cover on Angelica, who went to the belly. The belly is still intact. Count of one, count of two. Whoa! Angelica barely able to kick out of that. The match will continue. Byfuck back at, oh, Nevaeh screaming, or excuse me, Angelica screaming. Oh, here she goes, one and two again. Sweeping the legs. Oh! Clothesline into the corner, cut her off. Jesus. She was screaming again. And then, oh, Nevaeh Lee Hannah taking her out. Nevaeh Lee Hannah trying to attack on Flutter and Angelica. Look at Nevaeh going right after Byfuck. Takes out Angelica Lopez. And then trying to go after. Oh, no, no. Byfuck turns it around. German. So flex. May have been looking for the heaven calling, but Byfuck to a quick cover on Nevaeh Lee Hannah. Count of one. Count of two. Nevaeh takes out. Powering out from Byfuck's cover. Nevaeh Lee Hannah trying to go for Thunder, but Byfuck turns it into a backbreaker. Byfuck looking to capitalize here tonight. Oh, here we go. Byfoot now running through now. Byfoot trying to get with it. Under Bailey Hanna trying to get her out of the wing. I guess the Bay is probably the best one here. Throw the best to target her and get her out. Coming through. Boom. Got her. Oh, Angelica trying to strike, but couldn't quite get it. Angelica Lopez from behind. Angelica Lopez. Oscar connects on the Byfoot. Angelica Lopez goes for the cover on Byfoot. Count of one and a kick out by Flutter. Now Angelica Lopez gonna strike. Oh my god, we've got Erica on the receive. Angelica Lopez. Oh, taking her over there. Look at it. Is it a manhandler? Trying to tap out the champion. You don't see this move too often. Byfoot is in trouble. Oh, Byfoot trying to work out of it. Just barely. Oh, Angelica got. Oh, no, no, no. Byfoot got Angelica. Again, and now look at it, sleeper hole connect under the Rayleigh hand, and Rayleigh hand in a little bit of trouble. Byfoot trying to tap, we're trying to put her asleep. Get out Drawbreaker under the Rayleigh hand. I'm gonna try to get out of that when she done. Rayleigh hand, a right hand from behind. Coming up! Here we go! Heaven's calling! Connect! Count of two, Angelica powered out! Just barely getting out of it. Now for the Byfoot out of nowhere, flat suplex connect, and then a cover on Rayleigh Hanna. Gonna let her go, the referee down. Referee is on his knee. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Angelica turned the back the other way, Angelica Lopez. I can't keep track. Fisherman Buster, and then a cover on Byfoot. The referee is still on a feet, he's still kneeling. What is the ref doing? Get up, you stupid man. Two pins have not been counted because the referee won't get up. There he goes, finally. And now look at that, Rayleigh Hanna raining down gut punches on the Flutter Byfoot. Angelica though, taking the bay into the corner, Byfoot rolling out of the ring. Angelica Lopez, boom! What a bulldog from off the corner. Angelica now, looking for an opening. Take that arm, oh, went for a heel kick from Rayleigh Hanna, gonna turn it back around, Nevaeh. Caught him with a gut kick. Rayleigh Hanna taking Angelica into the corner. Nevaeh running through. Got her on his gut. And here we go again. And belly to belly over the shoulders. Tossing her like a bag of potatoes. Nevaeh Hanna. Oh, oh, here we go. Nevaeh looking for it. Here we go. Palm handle. Good buster. Really hit it. Oh, whoa! Went to take out Byfoot to go for the cover, but Byfoot gonna counter back the other way. Byfoot taking out Nevaeh. And now clothesline takes her out. But a Byfoot got an opportunity now. What's he gonna do? Dragging Angelica towards the middle of the ring. Byfoot gonna try to steal the cover. From the Bailey hit it. Move. Count of one. Count of two. Oh my god. Angelica barely able to power out. Imagine if Nevaeh had got that cover first hand, but look at this, Byfoot setting up. Rayleigh Hanna though from behind. Not gonna let it happen, Rayleigh Hanna. Look at this. Heaven calling. Count of one, count of two. Byfoot powers out. Now Nevaeh taking down Angelica Lopez. What a close call we're having now. Look at this. Rayleigh Hanna running through with clothesline. The Flutter Byfoot tripping her up. Take her down. Rayleigh Hanna looking for the one opening she's been trying to get all year long. Ever since her debut, she's been looking for this moment, and she's looking to get it now! Fisherman Buster! Trying to take out Flutter Byfoot, she's almost got it! Here we go! Look at this! Coming in! Boom! Palm handle, going Buster, but look at this! Angelica back in the ring! Angelica trying to take her shoulder out of the ring! Angelica Lopez got, oh my gosh, she got Byfoot back to her feet. Not going for the cover off of it. Oh my god, this is why. Look at this. Boom, Planter. Looking for an opening. Trying to put her away. Angelica Lopez into the cover, trying to put away Flutter Byfoot. Count of two. No, a kick out by Byfoot just barely. The tensions are high. The stakes are high. Everybody, oh no, look at this, Angelica Lopez, got her up an Angel Buster, and then a cover by Rayleigh Hanna, then a break it up right away. That could have been the end of the match right there. She had hit it, go slam, Angelica Lopez from Nevaeh. The Bailey Hanna continuously striking down on Angelica Lopez over and over again. The Bailey Hanna taking her off the rope. They had a body press, take the right down like a brick wall. Angelica forced the roll out of the ring. Now it's just 5 foot and Nevaeh all alone in the ring. Bailey Hanna, what is the plan? She's got a lot of options. Taking Byfoot off the rope, trying to go for a body press, but look at that. Oh, went for a clothesline over the top of Byfoot. Able to dodge it. Advance into the outside. Byfoot looking for a little bit of outside offense here against Bailey Hanna. A new opponent, a new rival, but Bailey Hanna going to send Byfoot back in the ring. Angelica slowly getting back to it. Angelica Lopez now making her way into the ring. Bailey Hanna got for a Byfoot, taking her right into the corner. And now tainted her attention to Angelica. Now look at this. Taking Angelica in the corner with Byfoot. Oh my God. Taking her up, slamming her into Byfoot. Good Lord. Did you see the spade on that? The power in Bailey Hanna. Proved to be probably one of the biggest on the entire roster. These for the women. Right hand to Angelica Lopez, placed in the corner. Oh my God, look at this. Nevaeh's got her on the top rope. Bailey Hanna up top. Look at the power, slamming her down. Already so far into this match, she's still finding ways to use that strength at her full capacity. Bailey Hanna throwing over the top rope to the outside. Uh-oh, now Byfoot from behind. Byfoot. Oh, Angelica. Oh, no, no, no. Nevaeh sees it right in time. Nevaeh with a shoulder block to take down Byfoot. Bailey Hanna got her on the gut. Here we go again. Nevaeh up top. Fisherman Buster. Bailey Hanna not wasting any time with Byfoot back on her feet. Bailey Hanna looking for the moment. The biggest win of her career. Got her up. Heaven's calling to the champion. Count them two. We have a new Velocity Women Champion. The one way to do it, the dream of Bailey Hanna, has just been realized. Through all the aggression, through all that pain she put through others, it prevailed for her. The triple threat matchup will fall into a victory for Nevaeh. Lee Hanna, the one and only Avenger, able to take down the champion and pin her clean. Flutter by Flutter is no longer the head of the Velocity Women's Division. You now bow to Nevaeh Lee Hanna. Throughout all the doubt people have had as well, she's able to do this.
And new W Magical Win Lee Hanna.
Oh, some aggression from that. Look at that. Nevaeh doesn't even want to be touched. And you know what? You think she wouldn't be a likable superstar, but that aggression fueled the fire. It fueled the passion and the fury of this woman right here who now hold the championship she must deservingly needed for her whole career. Nevaeh Lee Hanna is your new Velocity Women Champion.
Thank you.
The following champion versus champion contest is a Hell in a Cell match and is for the WWE Championship.
And here we go tonight, main event of night one for WrestleMania. It's the opportunity to be challenging Eli Creakey with a WWE Championship. TDT, the winner of the Royal Rumble, gets to make his pick, and he is going to choose Eli Creakey the Demon and try to win the biggest match of his career at WrestleMania. TDT has done everything he could up to this day, and one half of the Diamond Tag Team Champions alongside Hiro Mullins looking to get a win over Eli Creakey here tonight, and honestly, I don't think he can do it. Like, obviously, I don't want to put anybody down. I don't want to try and feed negative energy out, but, like, let's be real. Let's look at the stats, look at the skills. Has Eli Creakey really been beaten realistically? I guess he could win by roll-up, but I'm talking a clean pin. Really? I don't know about that, but whatever. TTT is going to try to do his best here tonight. He's not been known for being very good at singles matches, but we'll see what goes down here tonight. Eli Creakey versus TTT for the WWE Championship. And speaking of which, here comes Eli Creakey, the Demon, arguably the best superstar we have on the Chaos Men's roster, the entire Men's roster. Here comes Eli Creakey, the WWE Champion, looking to retain his title here tonight, and I guess you could call it his biggest match of his career too. Why not? Eli Creakey, intimidating in all categories. Good in all categories. He's got every single skill you could think of. Eli Creakey looking to get a huge win over his, I guess, arch rival? What would his main rival be? I don't really know if he has a set rival. Maybe, I guess you could call him TTT as his rival. Why not? I guess that's what you go with, but Eli Creakey, Hell in a Cell match. You know what? Him and TTT had a Hell in a Cell match back at the title draft pay-per-view. We all know how that went. The iconic TTT falling off of the Hell in a Cell cage, being choke slammed off the Hell in a Cell cage by Eli Creakey. That's an iconic moment in history and a moment that will live on forever. TTT's looking to get some revenge here tonight in a Hell in a Cell match, just like back at the title draft pay-per-view when these two first faced. Now this may be one of the final times they face, and it once again is in a Hell in a Cell cage for the WWE Championship, just like before.
Introducing the challenger from Dallas, Texas, weighing in at 210 pounds, TCT. And introducing the champion from the pits of hell, weighing in at 178 pounds, he is the WWE Champion.
And here we go, tonight's main event, WrestleMania Night 1, hosting TTT versus Eli Creakey, the WWE Championship referee with the ball. Here we go, starting off, trying to get him, a TTT drop the knee, trying to get him right off the bat, but this is the biggest match of both of their career. Whoa. Hello?
Hello, I'm back.
Where did you go before?
I just fixed my dog.
What happened to your dog, Michael?
I don't have a dog.
Wait, what?
Anyway, oh my god, it's blonde! I mean, I'm
not blonde. Well, welcome back, Michael. Great to have you back at the main event, I guess.
Oh, look, it's black!
Okay. Alright, so this is...
Nick.
To catch you up, TTT and Eli Creakey, TTT, let me get you fully catched up so you get the full...
No, I know what's happening.
Okay,
go ahead.
What happened?
Elon has killed TTT. TTT also has teleport ninja powers.
What happened? So
what did Megan the match with, or like the match?
Yeah, what's the history, if you know it?
The entire match, or just the, or the backstory?
Just between these two.
Oh, so basically, in the beginning of the title draft, whatever it was, Elok basically like killed DC with a choke slam off the rock to hell. So amazing moment, gotta love it.
Yeah.
Oh, nice backflip by the way by Elok. So, and then he and they had a vibe in the middle of that, and then they fought sometimes, but you know, he kind of lost trash, and so. I'm sorry, you see. I was watching this, I'm sorry. For the joke. The joking, okay. And yeah, that's it. They're rivalry. And you know, and you think he's gonna lose. Cause you think he's normally a one player. My team is Rocket League, I'm sorry. He's not really a player of one.
Okay, well, you got the first part right. The rest of it, Hadela Kriki was kinda all over Rafael Draco. He had a little mini rivalry with Draco. Had a little mini rivalry with Draco a while back. It's actually around SummerSlam time. TPT won the Royal Rumble, and then TPT and Elok's rivalry kind of started, but then Elok was attacking TPT after the match, blah, blah, blah. But their rivalry sparked up again. Oh my god, what is this? TPT, oh, kicking the chair right into the face of Elok Kriki. He ended up cover off of it. Kind of won in a kick out. Yeah, that's kind of what went down throughout the whole history of year one.
Wait a minute, did you just say
what?
That Elok was all level with Raphael? Isn't Raphael on the ridge?
Dude, okay. No, what? everybody is an adult here, Michael. No child weapon. Oh, whoa. No, Raphael is 25 and Elok Kriki is...
How about Benji?
20. Benjamin is 18. Everybody
he
here...
He's like 6.
Everybody here is... Oh no! Whiplash by Freaky, but I thought he's not going for the cover, kicked him on front. We're now going for the cover, he doesn't want to kick him in the face. Count of one, count of two, what a kick out! But the youngest person, what in the... Excuse me, we're commentating here. The youngest person on the roster, fun fact, it's actually Zoe Bolt. There are a couple of people who are 18, but Zoe Bolt is 3 months younger than Benjamin, as a matter of fact. If you got a mind.
Oh, I was gonna say she's a teenage.
No, and Zoe is 18, but... Oh, the top of the Hurricane Rana went under the steel chair! Beautiful moment by Elok Kriki.
I have a feeling right now. Because DDT did a cover, and Elok got out on one, and DDT got a cover on Elok, Elok got a cover on DDT, and DDT got a cover, and
oh my god. Hold on, before you continue that, continue that, oh my god, no! Oh, had him locked in a steel chair, neck first, and a Phoenix splash onto it. Is he okay?
He's fine.
No rules, and I don't think so. Did you see how he's grasping his neck? Oh my god, I hope he didn't, like, bust his esophagus or something. I think, okay, he did, yeah, okay, I guess he is fine. Somehow.
You can't really break that.
Whiplash won't bust it. I didn't say break, I said bust.
Yeah, bust.
Uh-huh, into the cover, and a one count of two!
Imagine somebody like, it's like, never mind. somebody pulled the dick out of this.
What? TBT, forward strike by Elok Kriki. Elok Kriki still going back, look at him go! Boom! Lands him right down! Not a good place for TBT to be in. Elok Kriki in the corner, clothesline by TPT!
I thought there was some intent in that, but like, hook.
Definitely. Count of one, count of two! Oh my god, almost got him with the pasta roll of the deadliest move in fourth entertainment.
If it's only been like, 3 minutes, I feel like he's gonna lose this.
Who? You like the TPT.
TPT. He's been count out twice. And both of them are two.
Yeah, I mean, Elok Kriki had that. Look at it! Boom!
But...
He got a huge eye on him.
But there is a way to win. If he does something if he does...
Final Destination! I don't even know what you were going to say, but TZT with his finisher move, and then a combo on Elok Kriki. Count of one! Count of two! And Elok powers out. Okay, what were you going to say?
I'm going to say, if he does something like really crazy, such as that thing right there, or call it scripted,
Destination, yeah.
it's even out, but if he doesn't like that, maybe. But I mean, also if he drops him, if he like kicks him off the top, he'll probably die.
Well, he couldn't fight back after that, back at the title belt, though, you know. But I do wonder if we're gonna see a reenact. Oh, whoa! Okay, completely missed. Elok went under. But I wonder if we're gonna see a reenactment of that between TZT. Though it'd be kind of funny to see Elok throw him off the cell again. I'm not gonna lie. Boom! Playing him down.
No, it could be the opposite. You know what I mean?
It is
WrestleMania.
It is. They're gonna have to make their way to the top, though. That's what they gotta do first hand. Oh, got him with a fling blade. That roll into a dropkick to the side of the head. The aggression from the WWE champion.
Well, how did he get up there?
They had to bust open the cage first. A kick out of two.
Oh, don't you think I have to like ask the ref?
No, you gotta bust out of it. I don't think you can ask the ref. Whoa, Hurricane Rana! Jesus Christ.
Wait,
what? I think TDC gotta take the metal himself with that one.
Oh, he's dying!
He stopped moving. I got worried for a second. He landed off the Hurricane Rana. I didn't know if he landed wrong or something.
He's just gone. And the match ended.
I mean, it is true. If you can't continue, then the match ends.
That includes, TDT has died.
that includes death, yeah. Uh-oh. Payton got up in the corner. Elok Freaky down on the top rope. Many Apple opponents. What's he looking for here? TDT. Oh, boy. Not a good place for Elok Freaky to be. TDT from the top rope. Make it happen in a suplex through the table. Huge move into the cover, trying to put him away. Count of one, count of two, powering out of two again. Elok Freaky seems to be in a little bit of trouble now. I'm surprised that I'm saying that, but TTP putting up quite a fight against the WWE champion. Now tossing over the top rope. Somehow they're going to have to bust open the cage if they want to get to the outside and get the top of the cage. I don't know why you'd want to, though. That's kind of dangerous for no matter who's up there. How you like, especially if you fail at getting down, especially also with the fatigue. What if your fingers give out or something, trying to climb up the cage or down the cage, you know what I mean?
Or what if you just like break your leg?
That too. Oh, wait a minute. Speaking of busting through the cage, a power bomb through the cage. Elok Freaky tossed like a ragdoll by TCT. Well, we're outside of the cage now. What was I saying just a minute ago? That's how you do it. TCT trying to clothesline on Elok Freaky. Shut up. I don't know why that came to my head. Oh, and speak of the devil, they're climbing the cage.
Wait, kick him off.
They want to go up top. They don't want to kick each other off. They want to bring the fight.
No, but if he kicks him off, then he'll die. That's funny.
That's not funny. On the top of the cage, Elok Freaky and TDT, just like old time at the title draft pay-per-view. It's time for you to see the square off at the highest point of Halloween in the arena when it comes to wrestling, trying to throw him off the cage, but Elok Freaky able to save himself. TDT trying to throw some kicks, trying to get him off again. Not going to work, dude. I don't understand how he's able to stay up on the cage after that. Boom! Elok struggling to get back to his feet. It's not a good place to be. Elok Freaky almost rolling off the cage. A back elbow right to the face, and he's bleeding. And a knee trying to get him off. Oh, spiked him on the metal. Dude, he almost fell off the cage with that too. If he had fallen off the cage from that, I legitimately think he could have died, and that's not a
good thing. No, technically, because he would have gone unconscious.
This is so unnerving to watch. Oh my god, look at him repeat the same thing he did at the title draft, but look at that! TNT, I'm gonna fight back! And now fight with Gary Wade, I'm gonna die, oh my god. I can't watch it. This is terrifying. TDT coming in with that twist of fate. Oh, fuck. Elok Freaky falling through the cage. What just happened? Twist of fate onto the steel. Break through. And Elok Freaky falling and plummeting all the way to the mat. What in God's name just happened?
Now, we've been to Mickle Hill. That does less damage.
I don't care, dude. And if you fall like 15, 20 feet. Well, Matt Hyde, wait a minute! Got him there! Trying to put him away with the arrow of fate, and Elon powered out! How is Elon still in the thing?
Nah, that's a pickle.
I don't even understand. Alternating forearm now with the back elbow, clothesline to Freaky! Dude, Freaky has not fought back in a while. Like, legitimately fought back with a big move. DDT had been all out the past couple minutes, sweeping the leg, trying to take him out with combinations of his own. DDT had always been known as a combination striker. Got him with the final destination! Wait, that going for the cover? What are you doing?
Minimum, man.
He backed him. I think he knows it's not going to put Elon Freaky away. I mean, it could. You can only take a chance. And what if he make the mistake that he made? Not, oh my god, no. Ah! Down free throw. What if he made a mistake that Elon can somehow able to somehow fight back in this match? That's just what I'm saying. I'm losing my voice, dude. It's incredible. Elon Freaky trying to muscle his way back to the seat. He's setting up for something, but Elon is fighting back. What is TDT doing? TDT taking him off the rope. Yapatune throw! Drop kick out of midair! Gonna pop up and take him out. Elon swings in a good corner by TDT, a right hand. TDT meeting him off the rope. TDT another drop kick out of midair. Elon Freaky can barely fight back at this point. Elon's back in the ring though, but TDT meets him with a side rushing leg sweep. There's not much Elon Freaky can do if he can't fight back here. And then a corner, Elon in a world of trouble. TDT rolling through, TDT up the rope! Drop kick to the side of the head! Trying to put him away, now on the top rope, TDT! Looking to fly! From up high! A moonsault connects onto the champion! Trying to wear him down, try to inflict as much pain as possible if you can onto Elon Freaky, and it seems to be working. Freaky still not fighting back. Go for a cover soon. Hit a big move and go for the cover. Oh, up top of Elon, Elon able to fight back. Elon out of nowhere, getting his mojo back, but no, TDT back the other way again. TDT with the knee from behind, and went face first in the turnbuckle. TDT mustering him back with Elon, trying to fight back, take him out to the apron. And Elon Freaky is somehow so in this match, right hand sent right into the steel. Elon Freaky may have finally been able to recover. I don't know how, but oh wait a minute, he's the tape player when I'm back in the ring. Gonna roll himself in a right hand. DDT taking it to the corner. Elon Freaky trying to turn the tide around. Elon, that's the plan, trying to turn him again, but look at this. DDT taking him into the corner. It is just again and again. These two swinging each other back and forth. But Elon Freaky able to work back the other way. Elon Freaky, trying to go for a combination with a knee strike. Here comes Elon Freaky running through with that boot and that spinning. Oh, bless you. He's majestic. Oh, wait a minute. DDT with a twist of fate. Brutal. More brutal than normal. TDT trying to go for something, but how is Elon Freaky still able to fight back? Look at him! How are you gonna beat him? He's bleeding even more! How are you gonna beat a guy that can fight that? I'm trying to go for a springboard move, but wait, what? how are you gonna beat a guy that— oh, powerbomb! Able to counter the cave-in! I was gonna say, how are you gonna beat a guy that can only find a way to fight back?
Oh, I guess that works too.
That's what I was gonna say. Oh, wait a minute, Andre!
I like fine metal.
Oh, there he is! Hit the cave in! Yeah, Freaky now on the apron, looking to fly! Oh! Final destination! Out of midair! Into the cover! Count of two, and Elon powers out! Still!
And no, no one got out of midair finisher.
Right. No, I think they've been kicked out of before, but they're not very often kicked out of. It's Draven,
Emily did it to Madison, I think.
Well, Emily did it to the Archangel too, but Archangel kicked out, but that's because Archangel is insane.
But he's also black. I mean, I'm dead.
I guess. Oh, Elon Freaky came in! The TTT was trying to strike him with the chair, but Elon Freaky made it go back the other way again. I don't understand Huddy guy can muster all of that energy and strength, trying to go for the whiplash. He turned it around, whistling him down to the ground. Oh, he locked right back up. He popped right back up. How freaky. Dude, this guy does not stay down. Doesn't matter.
He jumped
out of the way.
I heard that he jumped. He got taken off the roof of the metal. Oh, the cell got like 15 million destinations. He got like 15 million like monkeys. Put the page. Of the card.
Yeah, he took
he somehow still alive.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Also, he hasn't bled yet.
He hasn't bled yet. You're right. I didn't even realize that until you said it. But he bled twice. From like two different
also
locations.
Whale.
On his face.
One's head and one's his like neck.
Probably. Oh, drop kick away onto the steel chair. And Elok took some out of it. Dude, Elok has wasted all his energy. And so is TTT. These guys need a break. I swear, this match needs to end like soon. How are they still able to fight back at a time like this? I don't understand. We got him back to TTT. Another twist of fate. How much can Elok freaking endure? TTT to the top rope, trying to find a way to put it away again. I don't know how much he can take an LLC and then a cover. Count of two. He's done it. What? They have to pin the WWE champion. He's the WWE champion. I don't know how to process this. So many twists of fate. So many arrows of fate. So many final destinations thrown on top of the cell face for the match. That's how you beat Elok Freaky. I'll happily take the honor of being wrong in this match. TTT is the new WWE champion. You gotta be kidding me. Out of all the things that I expected to see at WrestleMania, this was not one of them. But little did I know. What the hell? No! No, I completely forgot about Robbie with the Money in the Bank contract. Oh, you have got to be kidding me. TTT. He's the WWE champion, but he's got to defend against Robbie Vanity now in an official match, and he's already been through 20 minutes with a demon. How is this even going to be possible? TTT, ring the bell. This is ridiculous. I've already lost my voice trying to do this. The main event has just got even crazier. Robbie Vanity cashes in his Money in the Bank contract. Out of all the times to do it, this is the worst for TTT. End of night one, TTT trying. Get back to his feet. Look at this. Robbie Vanity locking up again. TTT is going to have to find a way to use all of his willpower to fight back against Robbie Vanity. I don't know if he can do this. Like, genuinely, I didn't know if he could do it against Elok. The fact that he has to go against a freshly, even with Final Stand, the opportunity of them interfering. And they have to go against a fresh Robbie Vanity. And Robbie Vanity is a good superstar. Robbie Vanity is a very good superstar. He's trying to keep on top, though. If he can just stay on top and keep Robbie Vanity down and work him down little by little, you've got a chance. He's so out of energy after a match with a literal demon, Elok Freaky. The best on the roster, I guess not anymore. TTT beating him clean. TTT has proven his point one way or another. He's the new WWE champion, but he's got to defend right away. After 1 minute of being the champion, he's already having his first title defend. And it's not in a good place. And TTT throwing over the top rope. Robbie Vanity looking to get some relay for himself, try to reinstate his career by winning the WWE Championship for the first time. At the Royal Rumble, he was going to win the championship against Adrian Emsley, but Adrian won by countout. This is Robbie Vanity's second chance, and it's probably a better chance than Adrian Emsley at this point. Boom, an elbow drop. Especially seeing Adrian beating Roy, but it doesn't matter because he lost earlier tonight against Raphael and Roy. So yeah, get wrecked, MT, Stephen.
Yeah, fat count.
Robbie Vanity with the WWE Champion. I can't believe I'm saying that now. And it's not even Elok Freaky. And thank God it's not Adrian Empey. It's TTT. Ooh, trying to go for clothesline. But TTT was able to scout that. TTT off the rope coming through. Boom! Caught him there. Tiger faint kick. Now back on his feet. Robbie off the rope. Oh, but TTT caught him with a drop kick. Outside the ring. TTT trying to follow after Robbie Vanity. They're going to take him right back in the ring. He said, don't follow me. Vanity got a chance. Vanity trying to set up in the corner, but TTT won't stay down. Clothesline by Robbie Vanity. Trying to keep down the WWE champion. Look at that, he keeps getting up. He's setting for a punt kick, but TTT won't stay down. The will, power, and fight of the champion. But then they're trying to go, look at that. He keeps getting up. Robbie Vanity just giving up at this point. Vanity an elbow drop.
TNT trying to find a way to keep the WWE champion down, but TNT taking him off the ropes now. Will they take another dropkick out of mid-air? This man just keeps on fighting. How? I don't know how he's still able to. He shouldn't have any energy at this point, right?
It's the pink.
Right? He actually wore this attire at the time of the feud against Elok, and now he's wearing it again at WrestleMania where he got his revenge on Elok, and now he's got to defend against Robbie. This is incredible. Right into the ring post, Robbie Xanadu looking to take him down slowly but surely in this Money in the Bank cash in. Nancy cashing at the Royal Rumble, but Robbie took a sweet, sweet time waiting all the way till WrestleMania to make it happen.
Xanadu.
It is smart. Dude, and the fact that he did it in the main event is incredible. And the fact that he waited that, he's so patient. He waited for the right moment and he finally got it. Thank God to him.
Yeah.
I wonder if he would have done it if Elok would have won. I don't know. I mean, I'm sure he would have.
I wouldn't have.
Yeah, probably not. I mean, he would have had 3 more weeks at the start of year 2 before the Money in the Bank pay-per-view, which is when the deadline is. You would have had 3 weeks to cash in, but you would have had to have a tie. So obviously, you would have had to do it either at WrestleMania or one of the Chaos of the Velocity, the 6 show 7, if you count WrestleMania Night 1 or WrestleMania Night 2, I got to depend. But he chose the time at WrestleMania Night 1 main event, and I have to say, that was the best possible time. This is what he was setting up for. A 4-point kick, cocking him across the head. Robbie did a top rope now. Cracked him in the skull. He's already been cracked enough in the skull. And an elbow drop to TTT. And now setting up, looking for the RKO. Trying to find a way to put away. TTT, no! TTT able to move out of the way. TTT, got him with a twist of fate. The moment of truth, looking to put away his challenger. TTT, boom! Final destination to Robbie Xanadu. TTT looking to retain in the biggest match of his career. I guess you could say it's the second biggest match, considering now he's got to defend against Robbie and a power out until he got the legs up. The shoulder up too, excuse me. Robbie Xanadu. How on earth did he kick out of that? Don't ask me, but TTT turning it back, slamming him under the ropes. TTT trying to fire up the crowd. He's got to stay very, very focused at a time like this. Boom! Back one suplex to Xanadu. I'm losing my voice, man. I'm losing my voice. This is absolutely phenomenal. The smartness from both of these people. So at this point, the genius coming from both of them. TTT in front of the top and drop to Robbie Xanadu. They're looking to finish it away with the leg drop. Rolling through, coming through with a drop kick to the front. TTT looking for the one and only opening. Another inverted atomic drop. Xanadu gonna fall to the mat. TTT looking for yet again another opening. TTT got him with a twist of fate. Trying to put him away with the signature move. Count it to Robbie gets the shoulder up again. I can barely handle this. Trying to square up to Robbie Xanadu. Looking for a senton, but Xanadu rolled out of the way. Robbie Xanadu, oh, bad time! Final destination caught him off guard! Why would you even think of doing that? Oh, he's not going for the cover? What are you doing? Go for the cover! TTT, oh! He made a mistake. Why didn't you go for the cover? It was a clear cover. You should have done it. Xanadu, uppercut to TTT, but TTT trying to fight back. Xanadu just not letting it happen. Robbie Xanadu, an uppercut. You should have gone for the cover. I can't even stress that enough. Especially after being so tired after all of that. One RKO can put this thing away. TTT trying to go again. Robbie still fighting back. Xanadu got him up top. Slammed him down with a suplex. And Xanadu seems to be out of energy too. I don't blame him. Standing over top of the champion. Xanadu looking to put it away. TTT may have the shortest run as a title holder so far. Boom! Right DDT into the mat. Robbie Xanadu looking to make this cash in. A successful one. Alright, win himself a WWE Championship. Robbie Xanadu looking for the RKO. One RKO can put it away, but no, wait a minute! TTT able to fight back with the fight with Gary. How on earth? Don't ask me. I have no clue.
I got him! No, an RKO! That's enough! One, two, nine, powered out! How the hell is DDT powering any clothesline the referee? What is he doing? What is going on? I don't know what's happening. Trying to get him. Oh, DDT out of nowhere. Back to Black. I don't know how DDT is able to power out of an RKO after taking so many whiplashes from me last week. He actually going for the rainbow cutter if he wanted to win, honestly. No one kicked out of the rainbow cutter. Oh, oh. My God. Yeah, most of them are to the head, yeah. You think you have to put a brain trauma after this match. Again, he takes out the referee again. What
is that? He's trying to do like brass knuckles or something? Or a ghost shot?
I think
an echo move?
I think so. He's trying to do something. I don't know what though. He's not doing it, whatever it is. Trying to take him down, waiting down right on the PCT. He's knocking down the referee. He's got to do something with it, right? What are we playing?
Brass knuckles.
I don't know, in the corner looking for a punt kick. Boom! Another punt kick to TBT. I don't know what the point of knocking down the referee if you're not going to do anything with it. That'll go into a quick cover. Count of one, count of two on the punt kick, and he powers out! TBT yet again with the shoulder up. Not the time.
Sorry, bro.
I was
yawning.
Not a yawn. Danity.
Oh, the yawn!
Taking him into the corner. What's the plan? Trying to get him, but TCT gonna push him away! The opportunity! We're gonna make a statement! Here we go! Twist the fate again! TCT heading to the top rope! Looking for the arrow of fate! TCT on the top! Here we go! Arrow of fate! Hook the leg! Count of one! Count of two! Count of beginning! TCT retains! The WWE Championship has failed. Cash in, Robbie, you tried. Somehow, some way, TBT mustering out to take down the best superstar once was, Elok Freaky, and then defend right afterwards against Robbie Daniel. He's already a very good superstar. TBT somehow able to retain, and he is your new and still WWE Champion. Defying all the odds. We've seen so many wins of a title, but this certainly has to be one of the best, if not the best, we've seen yet. TTT realizes his dream ever since he's a child, performing Jeff Hardy Swanton on his bed, almost breaking his neck. TTT, it's your new WWE Champion.